Douglas. The news starts now.
Economic outlook is uncertain. Lisa Brady, Fox News. That from the Fed chair as the central bank leaves a key interest rate alone again while they continue to assess inflation.
My colleagues and I are acutely aware that high inflation imposes significant hardship as it erodes purchasing power, especially for those least able to meet the higher costs of essentials like food, housing, and transportation.
Chairman Jay Powell is signaling that rate cuts are still expected this year, but they don't want to move too soon and reverse progress on inflation or wait too long and risk hurting economic activity. For now, he says inflation remains too high. Wall Street rallying into record territory after the Fed announcement. The Dow's up 291. Two Senate panels get a closed-door briefing with intelligence officials about TikTok and have more questions about how to tackle security concerns without violating the Constitution.
We want our government to have a very strong tool to stop nefarious actions. So the question is, how do we get that?
Democratic Commerce Committee Chair Maria Cantwell says they may hold a public hearing on a House-passed proposal threatening to ban the app if the Chinese parent company doesn't divest. A House hearing on the danger of China to U.S. agriculture.
South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem told the House Ag Committee that she's watched China buy up ownership of our fertilizer companies, chemical companies, and processing plants.
When they buy up our land, they will complete their chain of control of our food supply. Between 2010 and 2020, the Chinese Communist Party's holdings of ag land increased by 5,300%.
She says the system that tracks it is so lax, we don't really know who owns our land, adding that she tried to get a bill through her state that would have forced each land purchase to be examined through a new state committee on foreign investment. While that bill failed, she said they do now have new reporting requirements on foreign land purchases.
Fox's Jessica Rosenthal. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
What he's been charged with, mostly sunny, 48 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. Your radar is clear. Low temps dropping all the way to the mid-20s tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 302. Murder is one of the charges against a man who police believe was responsible for shooting up a bar in Broad Ripple Saturday morning. John Herrick reports.
Nicholas Folk is the man police say pulled a gun out of a woman's bra and fired shots into the crowd at Landshark's nightclub, killing Timothy Brown and injuring five other people. When asked about potential charges for the woman, the Marion County Prosecutor's Office said the investigation is ongoing and that they will provide updates as soon as they are available. John Herrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says Landsharks didn't do enough to keep its own club safe.
They were asked to. They were asked to monitor who they used to promote events, have the proper security at the door. Those type of things, they didn't follow those things, to my understanding.
Talking with WIBC's Tony Katz, Landsharks has had their liquor license suspended. One person was killed, another's critical after a shooting in the southwest side late this morning, says IMPD officers say it happened in a neighborhood off Rockville Road, just outside of the I-465 loop. Police are still gathering info. A one-year-old boy accidentally shot at a Whitestown hotel room by his own father. Police Captain John Yerkosh says detectives are trying to figure out what happened.
If at all there are applicable charges, I know that they are working in cooperation with the family.
The child has been moved to a hospital. Strong winds and no rain could bring about fires if you're not careful, says Casey Fuson with the National Weather Service.
Just some dry ground out there, so it's really conducive for any small fire that might be started, say from like a discarded cigarette butt, that could then create a small fire along the sides of roads.
She's mostly concerned about central and southern Indiana. And Indiana State Senator Jean Brough passed away today, 2 days after she announced plans to spend more time with her family while dealing with some health issues. She was first appointed to the Senate in 2006. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:04.
With the weather changing, March is a critical time to check your home's windows. If yours are cracked or leaking and won't open or stay open, then it's time to call the pros at Window Nation. Right now, for every two windows you buy, you'll get two windows free. There's no limit to how much you could save. Plus, you could save even more with zero down, zero interest, and zero payments for 24 months. Window Nation's windows come with a lifetime warranty and can be installed in 1 day or less.
With proven quality service, it's no wonder thousands of homeowners have trusted Window Nation for their homes
and you can too. If your old windows and high energy costs from this past winter are cutting deep into your finances, don't miss out. With this unlimited deal, buy two, get two free, plus zero down, zero interest, and no payments for 24 months. You can't afford to wait. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com. Schedule your free in-home estimate.
The traffic on the fives at 305. Here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at westbound 70 Hendricks County stop-and-go traffic right now. Barely moving through a work zone. Starting at State Road 39, we run out about 2.5 miles. All because that the right lane is closed right now, and this has been extended. It's supposed to end tonight. We're doing this until Friday at midnight. Traffic sponsored by Allstate. Some people just know the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate, not one based on anyone else. Visit Allstate.com or call for a quote today. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
We'll see a partly cloudy sky today. It is going to be a bit breezy. Highs today near 47. Mostly clear. Winds ease tonight with lows near 25. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weird?
My name is Nigel. That's Jason Hammer right over there. Let's go through these charges one more time that have officially been filed against the Broad Ripple shooter, the guy that opened fire in land sharks, killing one, injuring several others. There's one count of murder, three counts of aggravated battery, two counts of battery with a deadly weapon, and then it's this last one that has my eyebrows raised. One count of possession of a firearm by a serious violent felon. It's that last one that raises a few questions, Hammer.
Serious violent felon, meaning you are not legally allowed to possess a firearm. Okay, fine. I understand. Bad guys will find ways to be bad guys.
Yes.
But the questions that I have are for the prosecutor, Ryan Mears, the prosecutor's office, and some of the judges in Marion County. So what is this serious violent felony that this guy was previously convicted for? And how much time did he do? And also, what was the basis of this sweetheart plea deal that the prosecutor, Ryan Mears, and this judge had? Why did the judge approve it? These are all fair questions because could this have been avoided?
That's the big question. Could this thing have been prevented? Was the shooting preventable if there wasn't some sort of sweetheart plea deal for a previous conviction?
And listen, we're not talking about misdemeanors here. Serious violent felon. Those are three pretty big words right there. And it happens time and time again here in Indianapolis where the prosecutor is more concerned about finding the root cause than locking up trash and keeping them off the streets. Now, I understand you can't lock up everybody. We've heard Boss Hogsett in those rare moments when he's been sober say that over and over again. Well, we can't lock up everybody. Okay, fine. Let's figure something out.
I don't want to lock up everybody.
Right. Let's figure something out. Let's maybe make a deal. I'm open to deals. I'm open to plea deals for folks that are not injuring, hurting, or killing people. If it's a victimless crime, let's have a conversation. But serious violent felons, threats to society, need to be locked up. And I'm sorry, I'm all for jail reform and all this other stuff that makes people feel good, but sometime you just have to lock up a rotten bastard for a long time.
So again, the question remains, what is the serious violent felony? Because one of the charges from the guy that opened fire in land sharks, one count of possession of a firearm by a serious violent felon. Well, what was that serious previous serious violent felony, and how much time did he do, and what was the basis of the sweetheart plea deal, Mears, and why did the judge approve it?
And again, sometimes it feels like I'm just talking into a mirror, though, because 60% of the vote, 60% of voters in Central Indy hitched their wagon to Ryan Mears for a couple more years the last time he was up for election against a good candidate. and Cindy Carrasco.
You see any of that surveillance video from the shooting?
I did. And what I saw was the suspect and a female walk in together. He reaches down into her bra and pulls out the gun. And then a few minutes go by, and it turns out that was the gun that was fired inside of Landsharks.
So wait, they got through security, according to reports, according to news reports. I think we saw this on Fox 59. The owners of Landsharks say their security guards were wanding people. They pat them down. But in this case, the owners of Landsharks say the gun was in the woman's bra and it made it difficult to search.
So either it was a half-ass wanding effort or they didn't wand her at all. Because it would have gone off if you just do the standard wanding, like you're going into a Pacers game or something like that. So a lot of questions here, an awful lot of questions. In national news, Nige, we've got an update from the Georgia case against Donald Trump. So last week, if you remember, this judge, who was also a donor, said that the DA, Fannie Willis,
Big Fat Fanny,
there it is,
was allowed to stay on the case as long as she dumped her married and unqualified lover off of the case. Because these two were allegedly doing the hibbity-dibbity. She paid this guy, who again was completely unqualified to handle a case of this magnitude, big time bucks. And in return, he was flying Big Fat Fanny around the country, buying her gifts, taking her on vacations. They were having an affair. Well, the update is this. The Georgia judge is allowing Donald Trump's legal team to appeal the Fannie Willis disqualification decision.
Ah.
So Judge McAfee, the same judge that has donated to Fannie Willis, issued this certificate of immediate review earlier today. So, I think we all know what this means.
Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until we decide it is.
Well, it just delays everything.
It does. That's
part of the Trump's plan. I mean, they want to get this stuff over with so they can convict him and throw Trump in jail. And it doesn't look like it's going to happen. I don't think he's going to spend any time behind bars. We could go back after this is all said and done, and if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I'll admit it. But this is all election interference, in my opinion, and Trump's team is doing everything to delay everything until the election.
Right.
Good.
So the defense team now has 10 days to submit an application to the Georgia Court of Appeals, which will then have 45 days to decide whether or not they want to hear the case from March 15th, when the order was issued in the first place. So under Georgia law, the Georgia Court of Appeals is not required to hear the case, but there is still a chance that Big Fat Fanny could be removed from this case. And if you listen to pretty much any other legal expert, again, I'm not a lawyer, you're not a lawyer, but people that work in this building are lawyers. They're crawling over this joy. We just talked to one in the hallway. Most of them say that this Judge McAfee in Georgia, made the wrong decision.
And so it's going to be the Georgia Court of Appeals that's going to decide this now? Or they don't have to hear the case?
They don't have to hear the case.
Okay.
But if the Trump legal team wants to appeal this to higher courts, then we've got ourselves a ball game. Now, in a statement released to Fox News, the defense team from Donald Trump said, quote, "We are optimistic that the appellate review will lead to the case being dismissed and the DA being disqualified."
Well, what are they going to say, though?
True.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, we don't think this is going to work, but we're going to try anyway.
Very defeated. Kind of sounded like Mitch McConnell right there.
I sound way too lucid for Mitch McConnell. That was way too clear.
I think what we need is to hear from AI Donald Trump on what's really happening with this case and if maybe Fannie Willis could be kicked off.
Well, we do plan to appeal. We want to remove Big Fat Fanny from this case, just like her unqualified lover removed that big, massive G-string that Fanny probably wears. It's so big and so stretched out. It's not a G-string anymore. It's more like a bed sheet with holes in it.
AI Donald Trump responding to the news out of Georgia today. All right, Matt Bear standing by with a look at the roads.
All right, fellas, looking to westbound 70 in Hendricks County. It is stopped starting at State Road 39 for about 2.5 miles because of construction. The delay goes out to Hazelwood a little bit beyond, and the right lane is closed. My information says until Friday night at midnight. We'll see how that goes, give or take, with the weather and, you know, whenever they change it. Northbound 37 stop and go right now. Epler Avenue up to 465 because of construction, and inbound 65 slows after 21st to Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates. It's a WIBC traffic.
We're going to have a lot more on this broad ripple story coming up later in the show. Mutual friend of ours, bar owner, will call into the show and we'll get his perspective. That's coming up later. We've got Kenny Chesney tickets to give away later. We've got Meltdown Madness. Is this anything? We are loaded up. But coming up next, you asked for it, you got it. If you want to get some big deals before March Madness commences, the crazy coupon lady, Crystal Hammer, makes her return. That is coming up next. Right now, it's 50 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Yeah, my sidewalk and front porch were just crumbling, falling apart, needed completely replaced. And I was just going to go with that basic, regular, generic-looking concrete, you know, that looked the same as before. But my wife was like, no. She showed me the Indie Decorative Concrete website, and I was just blown away at what they could do in terms of taking a basic sidewalk and porch. And they turned it into a custom-stamped concrete area with even more space and an absolutely awesome, unique look. So Indie Decorative Concrete's locally owned. They've been around since 2007. The owners, Mark and Jamie, not only do they run a great custom concrete business, but they're great people. Mark came out to the house, gave us a few design ideas, and then went to their showroom, and Jamie helped us pick out the stamp pattern we like best. It was an easy process, and they were finished in 3 days. Everyone who works for them is a W-2 employee, no subs working at your house. Bottom line is any decorative concrete's the best in the business. All 5-star Google reviews. So whether it's a new patio, sidewalk, porch, don't do anything until you've checked out IndieDecorativeConcrete.com.
PA Jewelers in Brownsburg is your place for fine jewelry. Custom pieces, one-of-a-kind pieces, vintage pieces, and also your place to sell jewelry. 3754 South Green Street in Brownsburg. PA Jewelers inside Premier Arms. You have old jewelry from grandma or jewelry you don't wear anymore? Come sell it for top dollar at PA Jewelers. I've sold jewelry there. My wife has. You're going to love the prices. PA Jewelers inside Premier Arms. 3754 South Green Street in Brownsburg. PremierArms.com.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Jeff Lynn's ELO.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why.
Live in concert in Indianapolis. The Over and Out Tour. Jeff Lynn's ELO, the final tour, all the hits. Live at Gainbridge Fieldhouse, Saturday, September 7th. Get tickets this Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com.
Don't stress about plumbing repairs. Call L.D. Smith for honest advice and a free second opinion on any estimate.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Aw, jeez, you guys are freaking me out.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
Stop it.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show. Hello, my name is Nigel. Jason Hammer right over there with a very special and lovely guest on the hotline.
She saves you money and she funnels my hog. You know her, you love her. She is the crazy coupon lady, Mrs. Hammer, Crystal Hammer. How are you, love?
It's quite an introduction.
Right. I'm doing great. I'm actually surprised Nigel's here. I mean, the last couple of segments I've done, he's been gone.
Yeah. We haven't done a segment in a while. Where have you been?
No, I've been here. You've been gone. Okay. You're always gone.
Didn't I hear Jerry Lopez one time filling in for me actually did, like, went through and did all your coupon advice, and he's like, holy crap, this stuff works.
Yes, I think it was the Super Bowl. He went and got everything that I had suggested, and he was shocked.
So it's a big week. It's a big month. March Madness officially gets rolling tomorrow. I know we've had play-in games that I may or may not have bet on, but the real stuff starts tomorrow, Crystal. So the task that I gave you was find degenerates like me, stuff that we can watch basketball games with, snacks and foods and drinks and all types of stuff like that. Did you have any success?
Well, first of all, I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing this because I have to save money this week because I know that you're going to be gambling most of our money on all these games. So
Tomorrow,
I'm going to be doubling our money, damn it. You're welcome.
That's a great way to think about it.
Yeah, okay. So, yes, I did. It was hard this week, though. I mean, there's not a lot of deals out there right now, but I was able to put something together, though.
All right, what do we got?
Okay, so again, we're going to my favorite store. We're going to Kroger. And again, you have to have the app on your phone. So you have to download the app, and you also have to connect your Kroger card with the app.
What okay? app?
The Kroger app.
The Kroger app, okay.
Yep. So I did find drinks, and this just floors me, guys. A 12-pack of cans drinks are regularly priced now $9.99 for a 12-pack.
Now, Crystal, crazy. I was told Bidenflation is working. I was told by the leaders of this country that it's temporary and Bidenflation is just a fad.
Inflation is transitory.
Yeah.
Hammer?
No.
Because, I mean, how much did a 12-pack of those cans used to cost? $5 to $7?
Yeah, maybe even less than that back in the day.
You could get like 3 for $12 or something like that.
Right, exactly. Well, with the Kroger app, though, there is a weekly digital deal coupon that you can clip that's going to make those 12-packs just $4.99 for 12-pack. So that's better than $9.99.
Correct.
So you got the drinks. Next is the family size bags of Tostitos, Fritos, and Cheetos. They are regularly priced $6.99. If you click the weekly digital deal coupon, you can get those for $3.99.
Okay, so we got drinks, we got chips. Keep rolling.
Okay, so then again, we're going back to the DiGiorno pizzas. They're regularly priced $7.99. They are on sale for $3.99.
Oh,
and
okay.
So that's pizza and basketball. I mean, you can't get any better than that. But the Johnsonville brats, they are normally priced at $4.69 a package. Again, that weekly digital deal coupon, you could get them for $2.99 a package.
Okay.
So now we got pizzas, we got brats, we got chips, we got drinks. I put a scenario together if it was our four of us, our family. If I got 2 12-packs of drinks, 2 bags of the chips, 2 pizzas, 2 Johnsonville brats, if I did not clip any of those coupons, it's going to cost me $59.32 I know, right? Because that's not a lot of food.
No.
But if you clip all those coupons, you're going to be down to $31.
Where it was in 2020, in 2019, right? Is that what you're telling me?
Right. Yeah. Right, exactly.
And now we got to work. Now you have to actually work to get those prices. It sounds like this Kroger app, though, Crystal, is pretty cool. I mean, we're giving free advertisement to Kroger, but I mean, hell, if you want to save money and throw a tournament party, it looks like this, you know, you got to do what you got to do.
I'll probably do this deal more than once because, you know, with, like I said, with Jason Fat Ass, I have to have it.
Oh, come on.
I was wondering if we were going to get out of this conversation without someone being called a fat ass.
Come on. I've lost 31 pounds.
Just so you know, you can do these deals up to 5 times each. So I will probably do it up to 5 times on each one of them.
And I love how carefully you have to say the word deal, because I know the inner hillbilly in you, the inner hill jack that's inside of you wants to say dill and put an S at the end of Kroger.
It is killing me every time that word comes up or the word to the store comes up. It is killing me.
And besides, you want to rip on me gambling. You're going to the casino with me tomorrow, too.
Oh, is she going?
Yes.
Crystal's going?
She took a day off work to go hit the casino, hit the tables a little bit.
Yeah, I am. I'm going to be on the penny slots, though.
There you go. That's where it's at, the penny slots.
Even the coupon lady in the casino, the playing the penny slots.
Hey, Crystal, this is just a question. You're the grocery store person in your family in the Hammer household. What's it been like for you the past couple of years, noticing the prices have just, you know, sharply increased?
I mean, the deals are fewer and fewer apart.
Right, because we used to do this segment every week, every Friday, right?
Yes, right. And I try to base my meal prepping around what is on sale at Kroger's.
There it is. We got an S. You can't take the hillbilly out of the girl for that long.
But I do try to base my meals on what is on sale at the time. But I'm not couponing as much as I did in the past because it's just I can't bring myself to spend that much money on products when I know back, you know, a couple months ago, I'd get it for 99 cents.
And it seems like these companies, Crystal, they're not doing as many specials, deals, or coupons. Like, you know, if you're a provider, if you're a grocery store or even a company like DiGiorno or Tyson or whoever, you know, you're dealing with costs on your end, too. You're not in a big rush to pass any savings out to anybody.
Yeah. And the other thing is, too, we used to be able to stack manufacturer coupons with store coupons. Now, every once in a while, that will happen. But it's almost like the stores now, if they know there's a manufacturing coupon out there, they will not release a store coupon for you to double stack. So, you know, they're playing the game, too, so that they're not, you know, that we're not able to save as much money as we used to.
All right, real quick, got about 30 seconds left. Reset the big coupon extravaganza you've got for March Madness here.
Okay, so we're going to get 12 packs of Coca-Cola or Pepsi products, your choice, on sale for $4.99. Family packs, size of chips, the Tostinos, Fritos, or Cheetos, they're on sale for $3.99. DiGiorno pizzas on sale for $3.99, and the Johnsonville brats, they're on sale for $2.99. Again, you have to have that Kroger app to be able to download the weekly digital coupon that goes with each of those products.
You are the best.
Hell
you're
yeah.
out of your mind, and I'll talk to you later on tonight.
Have fun tomorrow, guys.
All right. We'll see you.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Tony Katz here, and if you know me, you know I like my bourbon, and just like you, I like a good deal. So let me tell you about Hotel Tango Bourbon. Hotel Tango is a distillery right here in Indianapolis, started by Travis Barnes, a Marine who served 3 tours in Iraq. He wanted to craft spirits with the same discipline he learned in the Marine Corps. That's what Hotel Tango does. I've tried his bourbon. It's wonderful. It's a 4-grain bourbon with a distinct mash bill. You get a little caramel and some of that aroma. You get a nice rye kick to balance it out. I'm not the only one who thinks it's Spirits Good. Wine Enthusiast gave it a 94, and it won a gold at the San Francisco Spirits Competition. It's also under $40. Did I mention that? One of the 10 best bourbons under $40, according to Wine Enthusiast. Try it for yourself. Head down to wherever you buy fine spirits and try Hotel Tango for yourself. You'll be supporting local, supporting veterans, and getting yourself a great, sippable, enjoyable bourbon at a great price. Thanks to Hotel Tango for sponsoring the show. Hotel Tango, distilled with discipline. HotelTangoDistillery.com.
Hi, this is Denny Smith. C&J is offering one of their great discount programs, and it's one you've got to take advantage of to upgrade your home's water system. Invest in one item, it's $250 off. Two items, $500 off. And if you invest in three items, you'll get $750 off. They're also offering $25 off a bacteria sampling, something you should be doing every year. Act now and make your water system goals for 2024 a reality with C&J. They're local and they're affordable. 317-733-SOFT or cnjwater.com.
That moment when you realize your furnace is stone cold busted. We're talking a real put on every sweater you own, I can't feel my feet, penguin predicament. But fear not, there's an expert for that.
Let your local experts at Broad Ripple Service Experts keep you warm with $50 off any repair.
Like it toasty? There's an expert for that.
Call Broad Ripple Service Experts at 866-EXPERTS. See website for license details.
Indy's biggest party is back. Miller Lite Carb Day, Friday, May 24, featuring George Thorogood and the Destroyers. With special guest Gin Blossoms. Miller Lite Carb Day, May 24th at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Concert pit and VIP tickets on sale now at IMS.com.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
They might be closed for good. 49 degrees, sunny in downtown Indianapolis. Nothing on radar, low at 24 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:31. Police say Nicholas Folk shot and killed Timothy Brown at Landsharks nightclub in Broad Ripple last Saturday. He now faces several charges, including one for murder. As for Landsharks, it's now closed and may not reopen.
You know, everybody's having a good time and, you know, just, you know, doing what you do at Landsharks. You're doing some dancing, you're having some drinks, visiting with your friends, just socializing and everything. And then hearing something like that is just, it's a drag.
Customer Rod Wyckoff talking to Wish TV. Five other people were hurt in the shooting. IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says Landsharks is partly to blame for the violence.
But in this particular case in Broad Ripple, you had an establishment who was not working with the community up there. They established some things last year, some community expectations. This establishment wasn't meeting those community expectations.
Bailey talking to WIBC's Tony Katz. The Federal Reserve leaving interest rates unchanged. The central bank did mention, though, that cuts are likely to happen sometime this year. That would be the first time since the early days of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020 that any cuts were made. House Speaker Mike Johnson says he spoke with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu today.
You'll see the House Republicans continue to stand forward and reiterate our support for Israel at this very critical time.
Johnson says he disagrees with his colleague Chuck Schumer, who called Netanyahu an obstacle to peace last week. Indiana's second largest coal producer plans to lay off more than 100 workers this spring, as Woodward reports.
Sunrise Coal mines more than 6 million tons of coal at its Oaktown complex each year. They also have locations in Freelandville and Prosperity, Indiana. Those operations will begin to lay off 112 workers starting April 23rd, according to a WARN notice announced Wednesday. Indiana's WARN Act ensures protection for workers facing layoffs or plant closures. Employers in Indiana are mandated to provide advance notice to employees when aware of impending closures or layoffs. Wes Woodward, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:33.
Spring in Indy, and if you hate to paint, do what your neighbor Don did. He called Rhino Shield.
Well, the home was built in 1948. Paint on the aluminum siding was peeling, and I couldn't find anyone who would repaint it until I called Rhino Shield.
Rhino Shield's better than paint, and the crew?
Painted all my aluminum siding, and I've got a front porch that runs the whole length of the house, and all the pillars. and everything. And once they were gone, I couldn't even tell that they were there.
With Rhino Shield's 25-year transferable warranty, you'll never have to paint your home again. And right now, you can have Rhino Shield for 15% off the regular price.
Well, I've told a lot of people, do the Rhino Shield. It's really a great product, and if you don't want to paint the house, that would be the way to go.
Here's Rhino Shield's Shane Smith.
This offer is limited, so call me at 888-RHINO-41. That's 888-RHINO-41.
Don't paint.
Don't vinyl.
Go Rhino!
Never paint your house again.
With traffic at 3:34, what's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison, I'm looking at westbound 70 in Hendricks County, and it's bad. Stop traffic right now for about 2.5 miles because of road construction. They have the right lane closed, and this could be going on for a couple more days. Right now it says midnight of Friday. We shall see. Northbound 37, stop-and-go traffic, Epler to 465. That's a construction zone. Inbound 65, stop-and-go 21st to Meridian Penn. And reminder that the entrance from west 71st to northbound 65 is shut down because of construction. And that's going on until May 23rd. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the wind slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Drew Narsutis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Nigel Show.
Yeah, lots of action in D.C. today. Lots of different hearings. Capitol Hill, Ohio. Here's Ohio Rep. Jim Jordan. He's usually good for a hot take. Jim
good
Jordan.
Sound yeah. machine.
Here he is kind of addressing the House with his views on what's happening with the multiples of investigations going on right now.
When did the pipe bombs on January 6th? Nobody seems to know. Who leaked the Dobbs draft opinion? You know.
Yeah.
The leak that led to an assassination attempt on Justice Kavanaugh. How about this one? Who left cocaine at the White House? Biden administration doesn't seem to have time to answer these questions. They're too busy investigating parents at school board meetings, labeling Catholics extremists, retaliating against whistleblowers. They're too busy putting together a sweetheart deal for Hunter Biden, a deal that got laughed out of court. And oh, the guy who put together the deal that got laughed out of court, that's the guy they name special counsel. You know what Democrats do have time for? Going after President Trump. They've been doing it for 8 years.
Yeah, look, that's fine. Everything's good. And we're going to play some clips here. Some more on the Biden crime family hearings. Hunter Biden's former business associate, Babalinsky.
Babalinsky!
Was throwing some fire today. But like when... What are they going to do about it? When are we going to actually accomplish something with these hearings?
Right.
When is something going to get handed to the Department of Justice and say, hey, look, here's our findings. Now do with them what you will, even though it's Biden's DOJ.
Right. They're completely in the tank. Yeah. But you make a great point. I like Jim Jordan. He's got a lot of passion. He's a fiery guy. But you got the majority in the House.
Slim.
Don't sit there and bitch and moan about how, well, I can't believe the Bidens aren't going to arrest themselves. Are you really shocked about that? Do something about it.
You see Joe Biden putting handcuffs on Hunter?
Sorry, it's the right thing to do, Bal. No, you're right. It's a very razor-thin majority. But you have the majority, and you have to try. So I'm kind of over all of these hearings. We hear great sound bites. We hear trash talk. We hear zingers. It makes for good radio because we listen to these things and we're like, wow, he's really bringing the heat. But at the end of the night, nothing ever happens. Nothing. So that being said, let's talk about another hearing where probably nothing will happen. This was a hearing today into the Biden crime family.
And this is a hearing that Hunter Biden backed out of, by the way. Remember, he testified in closed doors. And then he was going to testify in open court, but now,
right.
Or not court, but he backed out.
He was subpoenaed, yeah. And he gave it the finger, basically, just didn't show up today. So in this hearing today, Hunter's former business associate, former Navy member Tony Bobulinski. Listen to this. On the mic, and kind of unsolicited, nobody was pushing his buttons here, he just openly calls Democrat reps Jamie Raskin and Dan Goldman, the guy that looks like Al Bundy, liars right to their faces at a hearing on Capitol Hill.
That the same people preaching this mantra know better. They continue to lie directly to the American people without hesitation and remorse. Rep. Dan Goldman and Jamie Raskin, both lawyers, and Mr. Goldman, a former prosecutor with the SDNY from New York, will continue to lie today in this hearing and then go straight to the media to tell more lies. Hunter Biden's defense attorney, Abby Lowell, weaponizes letters to Congress to try to smear my name
Mr.
and
Chairman.
State the cold hard facts
Mr. Chairman.
In an attempt to save his powerfully connected client Wait. And his father.
I mean, that caused a ruckus.
Yes.
Right there. Raskin was pissed, tried to interrupt Bobulinski. You go on listening to that clip, and are you going to allow him to say this, basically? And the chairman said, yeah, I am.
It reminded me of wrestling, WWE, because that wasn't testimony. That was Bobulinski cutting a promo. Now, let me tell you something, Raskin. Let me tell you something, Al Bundy. I mean, like, that's basically what it was. He was up there in the middle of the ring cutting a promo. I was waiting for him to end the whole thing by saying, if you smell what Bobulinski is cooking. Now, on the other side, because the Democrats had their folks to bring in, too, their big smoking gun, their big home run hitter the Democrats brought in was this cat named Lev Parnas. Now, if you remember Lev.
Sounds familiar.
He was part of the impeachment hearings, and he's also a convicted felon. So the convicted felon had the microphone and basically was saying, look, the Bidens have done nothing wrong. All the money between Ukraine and Hunter and all the Bidens is legit. The real problem are evil Russian agents who are in collusion with the Trumps.
The only information ever pushed on the Bidens in Ukraine has come from one source and one source only, Russia and Russian agents. The impeachment proceedings that bring us here now are predicated on false information spread by the Kremlin.
We're still playing the hits. We're still playing Russian collusion.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. Well, you go with what works.
Did it really work for him? Because he went to federal prison. Parnas, if you remember, along with one of his associates, were arrested in 2019 at Dulles International Airport and charged with planning to direct funds from a foreign government to, quote, U.S. politicians while trying to influence United States-Ukraine relations.
What do you know?
So this is a real credible guy the Democrats brought in today, old Lev Parnas. Also in Washington, D.C. today, again, a lot going on. We had a hot mic moment, Nige. Hot mic.
Really?
I love it when people forget that the mic is hot. And you have Texas GOP rep Mike McCall. He told fellow Republican from California, Daryl Issa, to go bleep himself on a hot mic in the middle of a committee hearing.
His time has expired. Ms. Miller Meeks is recognized.
Oh, I didn't realize. Thank
You've
you.
You've been keeping a 5-minute.
I thought rule. It was done. I thought it was. Okay. I thought it was a closing right. act, Chairman.
Yeah, go f*** yourself.
A little right on right violence there.
I was going to say rhino on rhino crime there.
Absolutely.
Like a little Republican on Republican crime.
So this brings us to another edition of Great Moments in Hot Mic History. This was on Fox News when Larry Kudlow, the economic guy, was a guest. His segment had finished up, and Fox News host, I think this was Sandra Smith, was getting ready to transition to the next story, and the story was about Kamala Harris. But the problem is they forgot to turn down Larry Kudlow's mic.
But they better understand what goes up can go down.
It's a great point. All right, we'll be watching tonight.
Glad to have you as a colleague, Larry. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
And coming up,
in many ways, we're starting from scratch on something that's been raging for almost an entire year.
That was Vice President Kamala Harris making false claims about the administration's back.
Unbelievable falsehoods.
And that is Larry Kudlow weighing in.
We got three BSs out of him before they realized the old man's mic was still on.
I love great moments in hot mic history.
How about when Joy Reid accidentally shared her real thoughts on Joe Biden's foreign policy?
Over the weekend, President Biden said he's ready to take action if Congress is serious about solving the border issue.
If that bill were the law today, I'd shut down the border right now and fix it quickly. And Congress needs to get it done.
Starting another f***ing war.
Starting another effing war. Now, I'm wondering what it's like in the hallways between Joy Reid and Joe Scarborough, because Joe was all in on Joe Biden. He thinks he's sharper now than he ever has been. Now, I don't know what kind of damning information Biden has on Joe Scarborough. Maybe he knows how he killed the intern, allegedly.
Allegedly.
I have no idea.
Whoa.
But Morning Joe is all in on Senile Joe. And last but not least, great moments in hot mic history. This is my favorite. This is an NBC News report, and they were trying to go to a live report from reporter Ken Delenian.
How the Trump administration is handling the transition with the incoming Biden team, or not handling it, we should say, to a certain extent. This time, it involves our intelligence community. Ken, what have you learned, sir?
Oh, shit.
Okay. I think we lost Ken for a second. We'll try to get him back.
Great moments in hot mic history.
Now is the perfect time for you to call the Bath Authority to get your project you've been putting off done this spring. Because the Bath Authority has an unbelievable deal going on. Call today at 317-532-5711. 317-532-5711. Schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. That's right. All you got to do is call today at 317-532-5711. Schedule a free in-home estimate with the Bath Authority and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and more. The Bath Authority does it all. 317-532-5711 for $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. Tell them Rob sent you.
Hey, when do you plan to file for Social Security? Just be careful, because you could set off a chain reaction of events with your taxes, IRA, 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your Medicare premiums. If you're not careful, it could needlessly cost you a small fortune. That's why you need to learn how you could avoid all of this with a free and customized Social Security analysis from Bill Demery. He's your retirement guy. He's my retirement guy right here in Indy.
If you've saved more than $200,000 for retirement, but have not yet filed for Social Security, schedule that free analysis right now by calling Bill Demery, 317-648-5120. Filing for Social Security, it's a complicated deal, but Bill Demery makes it easy, and you can get a free analysis right now, 317-648-5120. That's 648-5120, Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Congresswoman Spartz will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Spartz and learn a little more about her. Whoa, have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmakers' workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Spartz was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes, Spartz called staff morons and idiots.
Get this. Victoria Spartz says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich. I'm running for Congress, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Get 3 rooms of carpet clean starting at $129 plus a free hallway and $75 off duct cleaning too. Call 317-388-5141 online at ZeroResIndy.com.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
All right, Matthew, what do we got going on?
Hendricks County has slow traffic on westbound 70 because of construction. It starts before State Road 39 and then runs for 3 miles onto Hazelwood Road. That's because of construction blocking the right lane. Should be done late Friday night. Also, eastbound 70 stop and go to downtown. It's Harding to Meridian, Illinois. Southbound 65 loaded 21st to Meridian Penn. East side northbound 465 slows after Penn Pike 271st. Southbound lane slow from 72 South Shadeland. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's design centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Man, we get a loaded 4 o'clock hour. Coming up after the news at 4, Indiana State Police Sergeant John Perrine will join us. We're going to talk about the disturbing trend of shootings, road rage shootings out on the interstates and highways.
Just had another one last night. Yeah.
We'll talk about that. We're going to play a round of Is This Anything? We'll have a Final Four matchup in Meltdown Madness.
Ooh.
And we'll have my degenerate gambling pals on to give you some bets to make for March Madness.
Nice.
All that's coming up 50 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
So yeah, the real March Madness starts tomorrow, but there's some play-in games
right
tonight, right? And that'll determine who Purdue plays,
right?
And who
some of the other teams play. There were a couple yesterday, and there are a couple more tonight. They call it the first four. Those are the teams in Dayton, Ohio. But Purdue will find out who their opponent is with the matchup coming up today.
Have you spent money on a bracket? Did you fill out a bracket?
I filled out a bracket.
Are you doing it for money?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
And I'm doing the bracket for money, and I'm also doing individual bets for money.
Okay.
So, again, my degenerate pals, the professional bettor, and then comedian Scott Long will join us about an hour from now, and we'll talk about that.
I gotta tell you, I got a million different invitations to join, do the brackets. I feel like I just donate the money when I fill out these brackets because I never get even close. So let's see, and we understand how hard it is for some people to fill out a bracket, how frustrating it can be. So let's go inside the mind of a guy filling out his bracket.
And now, go inside the mind of a guy filling out his bracket.
Oh, man. I have 10 minutes left before they need my bracket for the company March Madness contest. Is this even legal? Well, I don't want to be the one to spoil it for everyone else by not buying in for $20. $20 I'll never see again because I lose every year. And I know that Marsha in HR is going for a three-peat this year.
Right?
I hate Marsha for always winning because I know she makes her picks based on mascots.
That's how it works.
And judging from her cubicle, she really likes dogs. Hey, that's it. I'll out-dog her. Huskies, bulldogs, Lobos? They're close enough.
This has been Inside the Mind of a Guy Filling Out His Bracket.
Wonderful.
And that's usually who wins the office pool.
Yeah, somebody who knows nothing about college basketball.
We played this yesterday, but I think it bears repeating. If you're wondering who's in the NCAA tournament, here's a little ditty featuring every single team.
Boilermakers, Bobcats, Bears, Bison, and Badgers. You got a pair of Dukes, Spartans, Gales, Flyers, and Lancers. Golden Eagles, Golden Grizzlies, Crimson Tide, Red Raiders. Blue Jays, Blue Devils, Cyclones, and Gators. Huskies, Hatters, 5 Bulldogs. Antelopes, Jackrabbits, and Horned Frogs. Cowboys, 2 Aggies, Longhorns, Broncos. 34 down, 34 to go.
Let's go!
Four Cougars, Catamounts, Cornhuskers, Cavaliers, Ducks, Owls, Eagles, Hilltoppers, the Volunteers, Tar Heels, Blazers, Raiders, Rams, and Jayhawks, Fighting Illini, Aztecs, and Peacocks, Three Wildcats, Three Tigers, Lobos, the Beach Seahawks, Gamecocks, Buffaloes, Wolfpack, twice the Zips, that's it. Write them down, fill out your brackets. It's March Madness.
There it is. And again, I'll have a little degenerate special for you coming up a little bit later. I want to make sure I get it all out there because I'm off the next 2 days.
You're going to the casino with Rob tomorrow, right?
Yeah, we're doing a casino day, March Madness betting, a little blackjack.
I'm guessing Crystal Hammer's driving, your wife?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. To quote Joe Biden, oh, yeah. Straight degenerate stuff the next 2 days. So I apologize for not being here, but somebody is weighed in on my vacation time.
Oh, really?
Somebody is upset that I'm taking 2 days off to just gamble and watch basketball.
Who would that be?
AI Tucker Carlson.
Well, March Madness is here. That means many college teams will be entertaining millions with highly contested basketball games that captivate America. It also means gambling degenerates will be blowing the mortgage on these young kids. One of those pieces of shit is Jason Hammer. This fat ass plans to miss work to blow the family nest egg on some 21-year-old kid from Grand Canyon University.
True.
Hammer is missing not one, but two full days of work to gamble, drink, and get fatter by the day. The audience of the very successful Hammer and Nigel show. They totally expect this half-assed lazy effort from Nigel, but not Hammer. Nigel is usually drunk or sick or drunk yes. and can't make the show.
Yes.
Hey, did Nigel ever mention he used to work at a rock station? Did Captain Cirrhosis ever bring that up? Did Mr. Midlife Crisis remind you guys in the last 20 minutes he used to do that? If not, I'm shocked.
Harsh.
That being said, let's go back to Hammer, the fat hillbilly that grew up in Beech Grove. This clear disrespect from Hammer with his big ears and back fat is unacceptable. The listeners expect more. Let's just call it what it is. Jason Allen Hammer is an asshole.
Oh.
I hope he loses every damn bet he makes and his wife leaves him for an illegal alien. At least the alien would appreciate the American dollar. The Hammer and Nigel show. Two drunks, two fatties, and probably a few people that like The View.
Man, a total undressing by AI wow. Tucker Carlson right there.
I took some shrapnel in that one, actually. Whoa. Man.
Sergeant John Perrine of the Indiana State Police, next.
Spring is here, and you want to be enjoying your life, enjoying the outdoors. It is impossible to do if you're in constant pain. Pain in your hips, your back, your shoulder, those joints, whether it's arthritis pain, sports injury, an injury on the job, talk to QC Kinetics, and you don't have to live with the pain. QC Kinetics, here in Indy, and it's the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. We're talking about lasting joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. Walk, run, climb the stairs, play golf, move again with no pain, no risky surgery. It's an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics is in Eagle Creek, in Greenwood, and in Carmel. Call today, 317-559-PAIN. 317-559-PAIN. Talk to QC Kinetics. They even have Saturday appointments available. QC Kinetics. Find the location closest to you. Eagle Creek, Greenwood, and Carmel. 317-559-PAIN.
Hi, it's Bob from Royal Spa. Soaking in a hot tub full of Epsom salts is the absolute best way to minimize everyday aches and pains. And we know all about Epsom salts at Royal Spa. Royal Spa hot tubs are the only hot tubs on the market that can safely and effectively use Epsom salts. Made right here in Indiana, Royal Spa hot tubs are the highest quality hot tubs on the market. Visit any one of our three Indianapolis locations or visit royalspa.com.
Ah, Royal Spa.
Denny Smith here for Sundown Gardens in Westfield. The Garden Shop is full of great spring decor, lawn care products, house plants, and more. Stop in and see their spring selection of pansies. This Saturday, March 23rd, is the spring kickoff at Sundown Gardens. The pansies will be on sale. The Easter decor is 50% off this weekend, all at Sundown Gardens spring kickoff in Westfield. Sundown Gardens is your gardening go-to for spring and summer at 186th Street and Spring Mill Road in Westfield. SundownGardens.com.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
Hannah complained of a headache. It was a rhabdomyosarcoma. The tumor was very aggressive, and it very quickly became clear that St. Jude was the ultimate place to be. St. Jude is an asset to the world. I think it's the kind of place that could teach the world a couple of lessons about how to treat people. If those lessons could be learned, this world could be a better place.
St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Finding cures, saving children. Learn more at stjude.org.
World-changing question. Are you keeping as much of your investment gains as possible? High taxes can erode returns quickly, so you need a tax-optimized portfolio. At Creative Planning, our money managers and specialists work together to make sure your portfolio and wealth are managed in a tax-efficient manner. It's what you keep that really matters. Why not give your wealth a second look? Book your free meeting today at creativeplanning.com. Creative Planning, a richer way to wealth.
Coming up in 2 minutes, John Herrick reports on the man charged for a shooting in Broad Ripple Saturday. IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says the bar where it happened is partly responsible, and why strong winds and dry weather aren't the best combo. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recyclers Studios. You have temperatures in the upper 40s right now. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 4 o'clock.
When no news is good news on Wall Street, I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. The Dow up 382 points at the closing bell, settling at a new high along with the S&P and the NASDAQ after the Fed did something expected, leaving a benchmark interest rate alone. But they still expect to cut rates three times this year. The central bank trying to get its timing right.
Inflation has eased substantially while the labor market has remained strong. And that is very good news. But inflation is still too high. Ongoing progress in bringing it down is not assured, and the path forward is uncertain.
Fed Chair Jay Powell says they've been right to be cautious after higher-than-expected inflation reports recently. Again, the Dow up about 400 to 39,511. President Biden visiting an Intel facility in Arizona, announcing more than $8 billion in funding and $11 billion in loans for the company for computer chip plants. Intel will invest more than $100 billion.
And this historic funding will be used to build new semiconductor fab facilities and modernize and expand existing ones in Arizona, Ohio, New Mexico, and Oregon.
The president's also campaigning in several western states, heading next to Texas. Avoiding a government shutdown this week isn't a done deal yet, even after an agreement was reached on remaining spending bills.
These bills will make significant investments for the well-being of our service members, for keeping the U.S. competitive against the Chinese communist government, and more.
Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer says a shutdown would be senseless, but there's a Friday night deadline and still no text on the bills yet. A former sheriff's deputy in Mississippi just sentenced to 40 years in prison for the racist torture of two black men last year. The longest sentence yet, as six former deputies learn their fate this week after pleading guilty. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
One of the charges is for murder. Mostly clear skies over the monument and 48 degrees. No rain to worry about on the radar. Low tonight to 24 with a few clouds moving in. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 4:02. Criminal charges have been filed against the man who police say is responsible for a shooting in Broad Ripple. John Herrick reports.
His name, Nicholas Fulk, and he's been charged with murder, two counts of aggravated battery, and more. Surveillance video shows Fulk pulling a gun out of a woman's bra and firing shots into the crowd at Landshark's nightclub early Saturday morning. Timothy Brown was killed and five other people were injured. Court documents say the surveillance video contradicts the woman's story because she told detectives that Fulk brought the gun into the club in his coat. The Indiana Alcohol and Tobacco Commission says Landshark's is closed in the meantime and the owners are not sure if the bar will reopen. John Herrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says land sharks had chances to create a safer environment, but failed to take them.
They were asked to. They were asked to monitor who they used to promote events, have the proper security at the door. Those type of things, they didn't follow those things, to my understanding.
Chief Bailey talking with WIBC's Tony Katz. Two people were shot at the southwest side late this morning. IMPD officers responded to Rockville Road just outside the 465 loop. One of the people shot was killed. The other's in critical condition. Neither has been identified. Officers are still investigating. Prosecutors filed a formal murder charge against Terry Davis Jr. after the 18-year-old was arrested for a murder on the east side last Friday. The victim was ID'd as Davis's brother, who died at the hospital. Davis was found by police about a mile away from the shooting, hiding in the bed of a truck. High wind gusts and no rain could bring about fires if you're not careful. Casey Fuson with the National Weather Service in Indianapolis discusses what has them concerned.
Just some dry ground out there, so it's really conducive for any small fire that might be started, say from like a discarded cigarette butt, that could then create a small fire along the sides of roads.
She says areas at most risk for fires today are in central and southern Indiana. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 4:04.
Do you get sinus infections, congestion, sinus pressure and pain above your eyes, below your eyes, sinus headaches? You've gone to the doctor. You've visited urgent care over and over again, and it's always the same thing.
I know. Let's try antibiotics and nasal sprays.
But the sinus infections keep coming back. The good news? Relief is possible. How? A minimally invasive procedure done in the office of Indianapolis Sinus Center called balloon sinuplasty. Imagine the relief of not having to deal with your sinus infections anymore. Set an appointment today with Indianapolis Sinus Center and find out if balloon sinuplasty is the solution for you. Call 317-528-9650. 317-528-9650. That's 317-528-9650.
With traffic on the 5s at 4:05, what's going on, Matt Pair?
Yeah, Harrison stopped on westbound 70 in Hendricks County for about 3.5 miles. Now the delay is growing. It starts before State Road 39, then runs for about 2.5 miles after that. It's construction zone blocking the right lane, going on possibly until Friday night. Southbound 65, 2 downtown, stop-and-go traffic, MLK to Meridian Path. Eastbound 70 slows 2 downtown from Belmont to Meridian, Illinois. Northeast side, eastbound 465, stop-and-go traffic, Westfield Boulevard to Allisonville Road. South side, eastbound 465, loaded from Kentucky Avenue to the White River. Traffic sponsored by Allstate. Some people just know there's a better way to do things, like bundling your home and auto insurance with Allstate. Visit Allstate.com or call for a quote today. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the wind slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm WISH-TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Drew Narsudis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Do you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
Nigel, Jason Hammer right over there. We'll go to the hotline and bring on Sergeant John Perrine from the Indiana State Police Department. Sarge, how are you?
Hey, I'm doing well, guys. Good to hear from you.
Look, I saw a disturbing story about a road rage incident on 465 that led to a shooting of a girl's car. Can you tell us what happened? And then maybe we'll expand and get into the big picture and get us some numbers about road rage.
Yeah, you know, it's terrifying. We've had these interstate shootings, these road rage shootings, kind of on the rise for the last few years. And the statistics are always there. But I think it really hits home when we find out the victim was a 17-year-old driver, a girl driving by herself. All indications are she just honked her horn to get somebody's attention and says, hey, you know, you cut me off, and bullets start coming through the windshield.
Hmm. So what's your recommendation? And like you said, we'll get into some of the numbers and the rise in road rage incidents here in a second. But what's your recommendation to a driver who, yeah, like, this guy's getting ready to sideswipe me. Does he even see me? Do you honk your horn? I mean, at that point, yeah. I mean,
I think that's the purpose of a horn. Is right. It's an emergency. Hey, I'm trying to prevent something from happening here, and I wouldn't discourage the use of that. I think what happens is when we start using horns and hand gestures in anger, and then I think it just escalates so quickly from there.
And then just one more thing: do we have any suspects or anything like that at this point?
Yeah, you know, our detectives do have some leads that they're following up on.
Good.
Nothing that's a slam dunk right now, but we've got a lot of technology in our investigations that lead us to places, and we're really hopeful that's exactly what it's going to do in this one.
Sergeant Jason Hammer here, and I admit, this is something I need to be better at. I am a big horn guy, and I've talked about this on the show. Sometimes it's just instinctive to put that horn on, but man, it feels like Nigel and I have been talking, you know, a lot lately about very violent road rage incidents, not just, you know, somebody giving you the bird, but shots fired. What's going on?
Yeah, you know, I wish I could answer the why, because it is scary, because I think the three of us are all the same generation that not too long ago, that's what you did. You got mad, you honked your horn, you gave a hand gesture, and both of you went about your own way. And now these incidents are just going so quickly to violence, to deadly violence. You just have to disengage. You have to take a deep breath, and you just have to stay out of the situation.
And by the way, the 17-year-old girl that was involved in that incident last night, she's okay, but bullets did go through her windshield and through her seat, correct?
Yeah. It's a miracle that she wasn't struck. When you look at the angle that the bullets went into the car and where those bullets went once they were in the car, man, it's very, very fortunate that she wasn't injured. But that's not always the case. We do have people injured. We're working a case right now where we expect an arrest soon on a different one recently where a guy was shot in the head, and he's going to survive and he's okay, but it's scary stuff.
How often are you guys called out to deal with nonsense like this out on the roads? Like, we found out about this story because obviously a 17-year-old girl came out, the media picked it up, next thing you know, it's on the radio, it's on TV. Not every story gets picked up by the media. How often are you guys out dealing with this kind of stuff?
You know, unfortunately, it's almost happening every day. Not necessarily shots being fired, but last year we had just over 300 incidents where somebody pointed or displayed a firearm in a road rage incident. And those are just the ones we know about. Those are the ones that somebody called us and said, hey, this happened, because a lot of times they don't call. Then another last year, we had another 56 incidents that resulted in shots actually being fired during road rage.
Wow. Incredible.
So we're just talking Indianapolis. This isn't statewide numbers. These are just in Indianapolis.
Speaking with Sergeant John Perrine, Indiana State Police Public Information Officer, and the other issue I've had, and I've talked about this on the show plenty of times, is aggressive driving. And sometimes people, you know, weaving in and out of traffic, going 110 miles an hour down. I see it a lot on 65 coming home at night after the show on 65 North out of downtown.
No, it has become a problem. And what we see, what we deal with, is two different types of selfish drivers. We have the selfish driver that says, hey, I'm going to drive the way that I want. And if somebody's in my way, I'm going to do what it takes to get around them, get past them, get away from them. And then we have the other selfish drivers that say, no, 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 that person behind me is going to have to drive slow because I'm driving slow. I'm going to take it upon myself to make sure they're not allowed to speed. And that's a recipe for road rage right there. Two selfish drivers coming together.
Sergeant, I know the IMPD is way short on officers, and they've had to scale back some of their, you know, highway patrol type duties. As for the state police, how are you guys in terms of enrollment, number of officers? Are you guys still out there on the streets the same way you were a number of years ago?
Well, you know, it does change and evolve over the years, but then the answer is no. We're about 200 troopers short right now from our allotment statewide. And we're low, just like everybody else. We're struggling to recruit. We're hiring right now, www.indianatrooper.com, if anybody's listening, looking for troopers, because we had 60 seats in this last academy that's in right now, and we only filled about 35 of them.
Wow. And listen, tell me if I'm wrong here, but it feels like when you're short on officers, they get put in more high-profile type areas. You know, they're chasing drug dealers. They're chasing bad guys and rapes and assaults. And that means there's less people out there on the highways patrolling, looking for road rage or things like that.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. And I can speak specifically to the Indianapolis district. We cover seven counties, Marion County and all the donut counties. We have about 200 miles of interstate that we patrol. We have 47 troopers in our district, right? Last year, they investigated 9,200 crashes amongst 47 troopers. They stopped about 23,000 vehicles, took about 3,000 people to jail. So we're busy. We have a lot of work, and we can use more help. And right now, we're being strategic. We're actually bringing in troopers from other areas of the state, which in turn depletes their areas of their patrol areas to help us on 465 and on our interstates in Indianapolis.
Sergeant John Prine of the Indiana State Police here on the Hammer Nigel Show. What should a driver do if they see something, someone out of control, someone flashes a gun, someone driving aggressively? I know a few years ago, man, I saw this guy driving home. Some guy, he must have been drugged out on something. He was all over the place doing 98. I called 911 because I don't think I could have lived with myself if I saw on the news. I mean, I don't know if they ended up catching the guy or not, John, but I called 911 when I was still driving. Is that maybe the protocol if somebody sees something
like
that?
Absolutely. Yeah, we need those eyes out there. We need those people reporting that to us because we can't be everywhere all the time, but we can certainly put ourselves in a position to intercept those when we get those calls. So, yeah, if you see that aggressive driver, the drunk driver, or maybe you're even witnessing road rage, give us a call because you might not see the actual violence, but what you see could lead to violence 10 miles down the road that you say, hey, I know I've got the make and model of that car, and it could be valuable to us.
Sergeant, last thing here before we let you go. Like, when we were growing up, I'm 46 years old, driver's ed was in schools. It was available in schools. You learn there, and somebody took you out, made sure you knew what you were doing before you went to the license branch and got your driver's license. For a lot of places, that isn't the case anymore. I know there are still some places that do it, but the lack of that driver's ed in schools, do you think that maybe in any way is affecting a lot of these people that don't know what they're doing out on the roads?
Well, I certainly believe education is important and learning, but keep in mind, if you're driving around with kids in your car, your kids from a very, very young age, they're learning. They're watching you drive. They're watching if you put your seatbelt on or not. They're watching if you use your turn signal or not. If you're a good driver, your children will learn from you. But absolutely, when they get of age, you've got to get them somewhere that's focused on teaching them how to drive.
And put safely. The damn phone down.
Yes.
Put the phone down.
That's a whole different show. That's a whole different show. But you're right. That's a huge distraction. And our cars are full of distractions, but the phones seem to be the worst.
Sergeant John Prine, Indiana State Police, God bless you. Thank you for your service and what you do, sir. And we'll talk to you soon.
Always appreciate your support, guys. Thank you.
Matt Bear's got to look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, looking at westbound 70 in Hendricks County. We are stop and go right now, State Road 39, for about 2.5 miles out to Hazelwood Road. That's because of construction with the right lane. Coming into downtown is slow. Southbound 65, stop and go before MLK to Meridian Bend. Eastbound 70 slows at west. Southwest side, southbound 465, stop and go traffic from 70 to the White River. Eastbound 465, stop and go from Westfield Boulevard to Allisonville Road. And on the east side, northbound 465. Slows from Penn Pike up to 71st. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
50 right now at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. And again, we are loaded up. Coming up here in just about 15 minutes, another Elite Eight matchup.
Oh, boy.
In Meltdown Madness, the final spot in the Final Four is on the line. We've also got some gambling gurus coming in to make some college basketball bets. All of that is on the way. But next, a spirited round of Is This Anything? It's 50 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Hey, guys, it's Rob. Did you know Universal Windows Direct does a lot more than just windows? You can get a new home at the same address with vinyl siding from Universal Windows Direct. Their exclusive Unishield Supreme siding delivers the warm quality appearance of wood without the costly time-consuming maintenance and repairs. But wait, Universal Windows Direct does even more. Make a great first impression and increase your home's curb appeal with a new entry door from Universal Windows Direct. Or how about this? Clogged gutters will cause major damage to your home, foundation problems, basement flooding, and more. With Universal Windows Direct, you'll never have to worry about cleaning your gutters again with their gutter protection system. Give your home a new glow. Call today at 317-659-7574 to schedule your free in-home estimate. And for every two windows you buy, you get the next two free. And tell them Rob Kendall told you to call and you'll get $250 off your project. Windows, siding, doors, gutters, and more. Universal Windows Direct, 317-659-7574.
This is the most exciting time of the year, and we want you to go all the way. Even if your team doesn't, march on, Indiana, in a Hubler quality pre-owned vehicle. Shop any of Hubler's 12 locations and choose from over 1,000 vehicles. Chevys, Fords, GMCs, Buicks, Nissans, Acuras, Mazdas, Hondas, and many more. All makes, all models, certified vehicles, luxury vehicles, even the hard-to-find ones. Every Hubler Q-certified vehicle is covered by a 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus a 128-point vehicle inspection and a free Carfax history report. Hubler's got you covered for 100,000 miles. Busted brackets not included. So what drives Indiana? DriveHubler.com. For over 1,000 vehicles, visit any of our 12 locations.
Hubler's got you covered.
Warranty on select models less than 9 years old.
You expect your home to protect everything you love, but you don't expect the ways water is breaking down your foundation and damaging your home. Cracks in walls and uneven floors are just a few signs your foundation is compromised. But there's one way to get answers to all your concerns. A free home inspection from Indiana Foundation Service. We put water back in its place. Get your free inspection at indianafoundation.com.
Oh, man. So Jay from Jay's Lobster and Fish Market there in the Garage Food Hall in the Bottle Works District downtown brought Hammer and I his brand new hot honey fried lobster roll. Incredible. If you love lobster, you have to try this.
And also in the Garage Food Hall at the Bottle Works District, Palavana Cubano. And if you're looking for the best sandwich in Indy, the conversation begins and ends with the Cuban Reuben at Palavana Cubano. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Are you over 30 and putting off life insurance? It's time to get a quick quote from Ethos. A better, easier way to get term life insurance. All online with no medical exam. Answer a few health questions and you could be approved for up to $2 million. Isn't it worth 10 minutes to help protect your family's financial security? Ethos. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as $1 a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at checkethos.com. That's checkethos.com.
Hey, it's Big Joe for Absolute Comfort, your trusted independent American Standard Air dealer. Owner Chris Wedekin sells the ductless Mitsubishi Electric Mini Split, which is a great option to heat and cool individual spaces while blending into the decor.
If you want your poker room to be dressed up, you could take a vinyl wrap and put on these. If you like the more modern look, they have styles in black, silver, and pearl white that would be more aesthetically pleasing for your rooms.
Find out more at AbsoluteComfort.org. Absolute Comfort is your trusted independent American Standard Air Mitsubishi Electric Elite Ductless Pro Dealer.
Hammer and Nigel presents...
It depends upon what the meaning of the word is.
Yeah. Is this anything?
All right, let's rock and roll.
Hammer, how do we play? Is this anything?
I'm going to run a couple different stories by you. You will be the one that breaks down all the information and gives us a verdict. Is the story anything or not?
Let's do it.
Is this anything? A dad in Ohio was arrested because he was constantly calling his kid's elementary school and the police, complaining that his kid was getting too much homework. Calling the police.
Oh, no.
Here are a couple of Adam Sizemore's calls, along with the Oxford Police Department, breaking down what happened.
Basically, the parent didn't like that his child was getting homework, so he decided he was going to call the school and call the school repeatedly. over and over again. He calls dispatch, I think it was 18 times, roughly.
Wow.
I want to talk to the chief.
Leave a voicemail if he doesn't answer.
I'm being very nice.
Well, then come to the police department, and we'll call the chief in, and you can talk to him in person.
I pay for him. He can come to my house.
Well, I'm going to send some officers out to your house to talk to you in person since you won't stop calling.
This is something, and I can't decide. I'm torn between, you know, on one hand, if you're this kid and your dad's fighting for you to get less homework, I'm all about it. But the fact that this guy is probably a lunatic indicates to me that Child Protective Services probably need to be called.
Right. Now, we have a mutual friend that is no longer with us today. The late, great Donnie Baker character, which was played by the amazing comedian Ron Sexton. Now, can we play that clip one more time, especially toward the end? I want you to listen to this guy.
I hadn't thought about that.
And tell me that Donnie Baker isn't alive.
Call the chief in, and you can talk to him in person.
I pay for him. He can come to my house.
Well, I'm going to send some officers out to your house to talk to you in person since you won't stop calling.
Did you hear it?
Yeah, I heard it. Oh, wow. That is very similar. What do you think? This guy a lunatic, though, Or is he just fighting for his son to get less homework?
Lunatic.
Yeah.
100% card-carrying member lunatic. Yeah. Is this anything? During a traffic stop in Mississippi, some guy randomly told police officers where they would find some skeletal remains.
Oh, hello.
Here is Commander Jerry Ford talking about the discovery and spontaneous confession from the driver.
The officer who was backing up went up to the driver door, made contact with the driver, and noticed paraphernalia inside his vehicle. The suspect at that time stated to him that he had information about a corpse in the nearby area.
And lo and behold, I'm reading the story now, there was a corpse in the nearby area that was headless.
And Ed Orgeron apparently was the man behind it, because that's who that guy sounded like. Go Tigers.
Yeah, that's something. That's pretty scary. Now, I'm reading this here. They haven't charged the guy that told them about the skeletal remains with anything. I don't know how he knew they were there. I don't know what the police officer was talking about when he said that he had paraphernalia in the car. Did he mean drug paraphernalia or like a big shovel or a giant bloody machete? What does that mean?
I believe it was drug paraphernalia.
Okay.
Not murder paraphernalia.
What would be included if in murder paraphernalia? Like a rope, a knife?
Yeah, like duct tape,
cyanide.
Some sort of a bag of some variety.
But no, this guy, so far, they have not charged this guy with anything. So who knows?
Maybe like the police chief is the only one in the county that didn't know about this. Maybe like everybody knows, oh yeah, that's where the body is, over there. Yeah. Like the chief just found out. Whoa, what? So maybe, just maybe, this guy didn't do it. Maybe he's just one of the townspeople that knows, you know, the secret of where there's a corpse.
Maybe he was trying to just get out of a ticket for the paraphernalia, for the drug paraphernalia. Like, that's what he was doing. He's like, man, I can't afford this. I'll just tell this guy where the body's buried.
Was it the movie Stand By Me where the kids were like, you want to go see a dead body?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Classic. I watched that a couple of weeks ago.
I think there's also a scene like that in Boys in the Hood. So maybe, again, I can't believe I'm trying to carry the water for this hill jack that may have killed somebody. Maybe he just knows where the body is.
And nobody said anything to the police.
Right.
Yeah.
Is this anything?
I'm going to get out of this ticket by telling him where the body is.
He's going to thank me later. Jenny McCarthy. Actress, TV host, former playmate. I believe she's married to one of the Wahlberg brothers. I think it's Donnie Wahlberg from The New Kids.
Yeah.
She was on Watch What Happens Live, and she was talking about the wild times she used to have back at the Playboy Mansion, back when Hef was alive.
Right.
Take a listen.
Jenny, what do you remember from your Playboy days?
Oh, my God, where do I start?
Really? Was it a positive experience for you?
For me, because Hef was married at the time. And there was that big Playboy scandal TV show special.
Yes.
They asked me to be part of it constantly. I'm like, listen, I didn't have that experience. Pamela didn't have that experience.
Right.
We were at a different time, I think.
Right.
I was there when his kids were throwing bacon at me in high chairs.
Right.
It was like the perfect time.
Yes.
But there was so much, like, still, like, sex going on with, like, gross celebrities in, like, the grotto areas and
right.
stuff like that. I went to of the party, so I got to see a lot of that action. Because there was, like, only hot women and the ugliest dudes. Oh. They were, like, really, really old. It was like Viagra Central.
That's something. If you think that I believe her, that she didn't hook up with Hugh Hefner, you're crazy. Same with Pamela Anderson. They all were. I think that was pretty much a stipulation.
Right.
For getting on the cover of Playboy. Like, she goes, no, at the time, Hugh Hefner was married. Like, that meant anything in the Playboy mansion.
I'm a playmate. I've got my dignity.
So, and the fact that it was just all old, gross men, Viagra Central, as she called it, well, okay, that's fine. They were still getting theirs. They were still getting some. She said she witnessed it firsthand in the grotto. Lots of sex parties with gross old men. So, what does that have to do with anything?
So choose your fighter here. Yes. 90s pinup playmate. Are you team Jenny McCarthy or team Pamela Anderson?
Oh, come on, bro. Pamela, all the way.
Okay.
Are you serious? Come on, not even a question.
Okay. I'm just saying, Jenny's got some qualities. She seems like she might be more likable and more fun, but I think I'm with you. I think I'm team Pam. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line, and the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Did you know that the tubs and showers installed by most bathroom remodelers aren't waterproof? I'm not kidding. They're not waterproof. That's because the other guys cheap out and put acrylic caulk directly on acrylic tub and shower panels. You can't do that. Water will seep through, and then you've got mold, mildew, and rot. To do it right, you have to first prime the surfaces, then apply the caulk, then you have to seal the caulk. It's a three-step process. Prime, apply, seal. If you've ever seen shower seams with mold growing on them, well, now you know why. Some cheapskate decided to save $25 in materials and 20 minutes of labor. And now you have a mold and mildew problem. Call Bats R Us instead. We never cut corners. We always take our time to do it right for a 100% waterproof installation every single time. Call now and get $1,500 off plus low to no monthly payments. Our number is 317-886-1761 or online at BathsRUs.com. That's BathsRUs.com.
Say hello to muscle this month at Colo Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram in Noblesville. Get down on the pedal of a brand new in-stock 2023 Dodge Charger or Dodge Challenger and save $10,000 off MSRP. March is better with muscle. See for yourself what it means to have the legendary power and precision of a Charger or Challenger at your fingertips. See the inventory at HelloColo.com or visit their exceptional new showroom on State Road 37 in Noblesville. Includes in-stock 2023 models only. See dealer for details.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
It'll take more than money. 49 degrees, mostly sunny in downtown Indianapolis. All clear on your radar. Low temps drop to the mid-20s tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 431. Simply throwing money at the crime issue in Indianapolis isn't going to solve it.
Indianapolis gave it a shot, but it didn't pan out. I'm Ryan Hedrick. IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says people shouldn't resort to guns to settle minor disagreements.
The simple disputes do not have to end in gunfire. Those are personal decisions that people are making.
Bailey with WIBC's Tony Katz talking about last weekend's Broad Ripple shooting at Landshark's nightclub, which police say began with an argument and led a man to shoot up an entire club. Ryan Hedrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The Biden administration will invest nearly $6 billion in chip production in the U.S. Senate leader Chuck Schumer says that's in large part because of the Chips and Science Act.
This investment alone means 10,000 jobs, 20,000 construction jobs,
and thousands of indirect jobs with over $100 billion in private investment.
Your Senator Todd Young helped put that bill together. The Fed is not messing with interest rates.
The committee decided at today's meeting to maintain the target range for the federal funds rate at 5.25% to 5.5%. And to continue the process of significantly reducing our securities holdings.
Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell, it's the fifth straight month rates haven't been changed. Monday's Delphi murders hearing had an order in place to keep everyone civil. Donnie Burgess reports two people didn't get the memo.
Rick Snay and David Noe are so-called YouTubers who cover the Delphi murders case. It's unclear what perspective they actually offer, but that appears to be cause for a feud between the two. They got into an argument at the Allen County Courthouse Monday.
Noe stalked me into a stairway and tried to get, you know, tried to start with me. I got right up nose to nose with the little son of a
Snay during a YouTube Live video. Both men are now banned from all future court proceedings. They'll have to cover the case from the living room. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
A good day on the market. The Dow up by 401 points to 39,512. The NASDAQ increasing by 202 to 16,369. The S&P 500 up by 46 to 5,224. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 4:33.
A sleep divorce happens when bed partners sleep in different rooms because one of them has a snoring problem. It's nothing to be embarrassed about, but it is unfortunate. Especially when there are simple, non-surgical solutions that can put snoring problems to bed for good. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula with Advent, where our exclusive focus is the nose and throat, which is exactly where your snoring problem is coming from. If 20 years ago you told me I'd be helping relationships flourish again, I'd have laughed. But in many cases, that is the case. Because helping your bed partner stop snoring so the two of you can get back to sleeping together again can do just that.
Go to AdventNose.com today to schedule your appointment and learn more about our effective breathing triangle solutions. Because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Breathe well with simple solutions. Breathe well with simple solutions. AdventNose.com.
Results may vary.
With traffic at 4:34, what's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison, I'm looking at a delay that has formed up on the west side. It's northbound 465. It begins after Sam Jones Expressway goes up to Rockville Road. And then westbound 70 at Hendricks County, jammed to hell right now before State Road 39 for another 2.5 miles. Full delays about 3.5 miles right now because of roadwork blocking the right lane. And then eastbound 465, stop and go on the northeast side from Westfield Boulevard to Allisonville Road. East side, northbound 465, slow after 70 up to East 56, and we have lights flashing red. AirTech at Ronald Reagan Parkway. Take turns there, please. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the winds slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Drew Narsutis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on The Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
You're listening to The Hammer and Nigel Show.
Tis the season for brackets, and our bracket is nearing the end, Nige.
Little tears coming down my eye. These past few weeks have been fun.
Meltdown Madness, presented by Window Nation, where we have taken 16 of our favorite celebrity, musician, politician, coach rants, meltdowns. We put them in a seeded bracket, and each day, you, the awesome listeners of this program, you vote for the one you want to see move on. We've got three spots filled in the final four. We need one more. So before we get to the final Elite Eight matchup, let's recap what happened yesterday. Yesterday, we had the number 13 seed. This is where ESPN host Chris Berman.
Love it.
He was hosting some Monday Night Football programming on ESPN. And I guess during his first on-air segment, too many people were walking around creating a distraction. So when they went to commercial break, he had a little chat with his staff.
When I'm doing TV and I got 18, God, can't everybody stop for 10 minutes? I mean, it's not that much to ask. Is that when everybody has to move, when I'm trying to concentrate? I mean, it's so rude. I can't believe it. It's so damn rude. Why does everyone all of a sudden have to move? I've had 2 hours to move around. Wait 10 minutes. It's like no one's ever worked on TV here before. I actually can't believe what I just saw. It's like no one here has worked on TV before. God.
Makes me laugh every time. Every time. It's strong, man.
That was the 13 seed taking on an equally strong number 5 seed. This is radio legend Casey Kasem. He was recording his world famous weekly top 40 program, and he didn't like the way it was flowing. So he wanted to get a hold of his producer, Don, to out why he's supposed to talk about a sad, you know, dead dog coming out of an up-tempo record.
He was a little dog named Snuggles, but he was most certainly a part of... Let's go start again. From coming out of the record. Play the record, okay? Please. See, when you come out of those up-tempo damn numbers, man, it's impossible to make those transitions. And then you got to go into somebody dying. You know, they do this to me all the time. I don't know what the hell they do it for, but damn it, if we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand it. Is Don on the phone? Okay, I want a damn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a up-tempo record every time I do a damn death dedication. Now, make it, and I also want to know what happened to the pictures I was supposed to see this week. Since the last damn time, I want somebody to use his brain to not come out of a damn record that is that's up-tempo, and I got to talk about a dog dying.
That's a slow build right there.
Right. Similar to Lasorda.
Yes.
Tommy Lasorda starts slow, but it ends with a flourish.
I wonder what the pictures were and how they factor into this equation. Like, what pictures was Casey Kasem supposed to see this week that he hadn't seen yet, that he was most distraught?
And did Don produce? Did producer Don ever get on the phone?
Don got an earful that day.
Well, this was a blowout, Nige. 75.9% to 24.1%. Moving on to the final four, Casey Kasem.
Wow.
I gotta talk about a f-ing dog dying.
So today's matchup.
Do you agree with that outcome?
I do.
I think pound for pound,
like, you would expect Chris Berman, I think, to maybe be a hothead. But, like, mild-mannered Casey Kasem flipping out at Don, that's good stuff.
I interviewed Casey Kasem towards the end of his life, met him in person, and he didn't give off the vibe that he was giving there in that clip.
Today's matchup, this is a good one. This could be an upset, okay? The number 9 seed, former Colts head coach Jim Mora. After the Colts had been defeated by the San Francisco 49ers at the Hoosier Dome, a local reporter asked Jim Mora, "Hey, you think you guys can still make the playoffs?"
Playoffs? Don't talk about it. Playoffs? You kidding me? Playoffs? I just hope we can win a game.
So that's the number 9 seed taking on the top dog, the number 1 seed in this tournament.
Yep.
Locker room audio of Coach Bob Knight.
I mean, if you're not going to recover Greg Graham, if you're just going to let him drive by you, if the rest of you are going to let him catch the ball outside the 3-second lane and drive all the way in here without one guy challenging him, then I'm leaving and you freaking guys will run till you can't even suffer. Now, hey, I'm tired of this shit. I'm sick and freaking tired of an 8-10 record. I'm freaking tired of losing to Purdue. I'm not here to freak around this week. Now, you may be. But I'm not.
It's too bad that's not the attitude of the current head coach of any basketball, you know?
The current head coach, I've done my job.
Yeah, I did my job.
So, voting is now live. It's on our Twitter, pinned to the top, at Hammer and Nigel. Follow us on Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it. Vote right now. You've got less than 20 hours. The winner moves on to the Final Four. We're going to start the Final Four on Monday, okay? Final Four starts on Monday. Who's going? Jim Mora, playoffs, or Bob Knight? If you're not going to recover, Greg Graham, vote now at Hammer and Nigel. Who do we got coming up after 5?
At 5 o'clock, we have Rob Sabatini, longtime bar owner in Broad Ripple, the Broad Ripple trifecta, Rock Lobster, Average Joe's, and Mineshaft. He's got some thoughts on the shooting that took place at the club just a couple doors down from his. I think you might be surprised as to what he has to say about the ownership of land sharks and the future of Broad Ripple moving forward.
So buckle up, put your big boy pants on for that conversation after 5. But coming up next, let's make some money. Let's make some bets. I got a degenerate special for you. That's next.
I'm what you might call very good at hide and seek. This one time, my parents had to round up the whole neighborhood to track me down. It was a mess. A lot of tears. Well, now that we got Xfinity, we have Wi-Fi all over the house, including all my favorite super secret hiding spots. So I can kill time in here by streaming my shows and...
Ha! Found ya.
The heck? How?
You left to find my tablet on.
This generation... ruining the game with their performance enhancers.
Get wall-to-wall Wi-Fi from Xfinity for a reliable connection throughout your home. Now through March 26th, get gig speed internet for $35 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add unlimited mobile. Plus, get Wi-Fi equipment included for 2 years. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY or visit a store today. Requires paperless plan and auto-pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Gig speed Wi-Fi requires gig internet and Xfinity gateway. After 12 months, internet increases to $60. After 24 months, regular rates apply. Xfinity Mobile requires Xfinity internet. Actual speeds vary.
You got to really understand and know what you're doing when you're filing for your Social Security. So when you plan to file, just be careful. It could set off a chain reaction of negative events with your taxes if you don't do it right. 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your Medicare programs. It could cost you a small fortune. Learn how you can avoid all the heck with a free customized Social Security analysis from Bill Demery, your retirement guy. He's right here in Indy.
So if you have not yet filed for Social Security and you've saved more than $200,000, call Bill Demery right now. Schedule a free, that's right, free analysis by calling Bill Demery, 317-648-5120. It's complicated. We're talking about some crazy stuff, but Bill Demery, he breaks it down in a way you can understand. I know this because I've met with him. 317-648-5120, Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Two rock legacies celebrate two iconic albums. Stone Temple Pilots. And live. September 15th, Ruoff Music Center. Special guest, Soul Asylum. The 30th anniversary of Purple and Throwing Copper, the Jubilee Tour. Reserved seats on sale Friday morning at 10 at LiveNation.com. Part of the Coors Light Concert Series.
Your new car, your new truck, your new electric vehicle is at Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield because they've got the deal that can't be beat. All of the new cars and trucks you're looking for and electric vehicles like the all-electric F-150 Lightning with seating up to 5, intelligent backup power, and on-site power for all your tools and gear. This all-electric truck is built for it all. Andy Moore Ford also has the rebates for you. Federal and state incentives. You could save more on your EV purchase up to $7,500 instantly on site and save more on all of their cars and trucks, their fleet vehicles, and their electric vehicles. Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield, including more to your door. You can just buy the car online and they will deliver it directly to you. Andy Moore Ford. Visit them on Main Street in Plainfield or online at andymooreford.com. That's Andy Moore, M-O-H-R.
I love Andy.
andymooreford.com.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Hey, it's JMV, and see the spring selection of pansies, houseplants, and garden seeds this week at Miss M's Home and Garden on State Road 135 just south of Whiteland Road in Bargersville. Miss M's Home and Garden.com.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
Matt Baer's got a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer. Eastbound 465 stop-and-go traffic from Westfield Boulevard over to Allisonville Road. Southbound 65 grinding from the White River to Meridian Pen. Eastbound 70 slow to downtown Holt Road to the South Split exit north. You're slow up to the Washington Street exit. Hendricks County westbound 70 delay has gotten bigger, and right now it's running about 4.5 miles starting before State Road 39 and then out to Hazelwood Road. That's because of a work zone blocking the right lane. I'm strongly considering US 40 instead. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
50 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
It is the Hammer and Nigel Show. The madness is here. Let's make some bets. Let's make some money. Joining us now on the hotline, my partner in crime, my fellow degenerate, the Heartland's comedian, Scott Long. Scott, how are you?
I love that I'm a degenerate, I'm a criminal, and I'm a Heartland's comedian. That is a good mix.
And also on the hotline, one of the best, the GOAT, professional handicapper from followneverfade.com, David Stefanoff, joins us. David, how are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you guys?
All right, Scott, let's start with you. Before we get best bets, before we get upsets and all the things that make life worth living in the month of March, what do you think about Purdue? That's the million-dollar question around these parts. Where do you have Purdue going? Your thoughts on the Boilers as a number one seed opening up here in Indy?
If you're a Boiler fan, go out, buy some kind of nice gift for the committee because they gave Purdue a gift. McCuller, who's the best player on Kansas, is out for the tournament now. It is a weaker bracket. UConn has got the toughest one. I don't see any team that could create problems for Purdue outside of the Oregon Creighton winner because you know better than anybody, Tennessee ain't winning in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, it's a lot of the same issues with my Vols that you see with Purdue, right? Great regular season, physical team, dynamic scorer. But for whatever reason, there's a head coach that can't quite seem to get over the hump. David, I turn to you. Where do you have Purdue?
I think, like Scott just said, the key to this is Kansas. McCullers, that's going to be my upset. I love Samford. I just think that's the key to their whole bracket. The only team I think that can give Purdue any kind of game would be Creighton. But you got to make sure these playing games, Colorado State won last night. These playing teams usually advance to the Sweet 16. I think they'll knock off Tennessee. But I think Purdue's got, Purdue's got the easiest way. McCullers out. Samford will beat Kansas. I mean, I think it's Purdue could get to the Final Four or lose. If they don't make it to the Final Four, they're just jinxed.
All right, so let's get down to the nitty-gritty here. Everybody likes a big upset in March when everybody's filling out their brackets. They're talking about upsets. We're talking point spreads here, okay? We're talking point spreads, winning money on the game. Give me an upset. David, I want to start with you.
My upset's going to be Grand Canyon against St. Mary's.
Yes, sir. I'm with you. The Fighting Bryce Drews, baby.
Bryce Drews, you better believe it. They're deep. They played in the conference. I love the conference they played in. St. Mary's, they started the season, they were frauds in the beginning of the season. But when their conference started, they turned it on. They got a lot of respect for their conference. But their conference is horrible. It's a bad, bad conference they play in. I know Gonzaga's probably one and out. Gonzaga probably get beat by McNeese. But I think Grand Canyon beats them up. The 5.5 points, 6 points, I took 6 points Monday night. I think the money line is great on this game. Grand Canyon is my upset.
I'm with you. I love Grand Canyon. Scott and I were texting about this, you know, back and forth the other night. They're a team that is not a one-hit wonder. They've had a little string of success here, and I love the Indiana kid, Bryce Drew. Scott, give me your upset.
I'm going to make it easy for you. Let's make it a trio. I like Grand Canyon, too. I hate how they play. They're a bunch of floppers. You would think they're their Brazilian soccer team. Neymar keeps on his feet more than these Grand Canyon dudes. But if the refs – man, that was good.
That's a smart joke.
That in a clip. I just came up with it. I'm just telling you right now, Grand Canyon, if you get the right referee, they're not just going to beat St. Mary's. They'll beat Alabama, too, because these guys know how to play in Alabama. Who who knows what team's showing up. So that, to me, is the one team that you don't want to have any – you don't want to be on the wrong side of.
Right.
They're going to get points, and they're going to cover it.
So basically, all three of us have Grand Canyon, which means anybody listening, bet the farm on St. Mary's. That's what you need to do right now. When all of us have the same bet, usually it's not good.
No.
Scott, give me your best bet of the first round.
I would have to go with I'm really a fan right now of Wisconsin. Usually I am not in the NCAA tournament, but I really like Wisconsin. Everybody's kind of leaning towards James Madison. Not many points in that game. This is a good Wisconsin team. They went through a little struggle, but they had a couple injuries. As I told you before, Greg Gard looks like an accountant or the guy that does your taxes at H&R Block, but he's got the team rolling.
David, give me your best bet of round one.
We all agreed on the upset, Grand Canyon. My other upset would be Samford against Kansas. But my best bet is going to be the Kentucky Wildcats. I know people, years past, they've been people have called them, you know, the Jinx, and Calipari's not the, you know, the coach he is. But I watched Oakland play two games in a row in person at the fairgrounds this last weekend. They will not match up for Kentucky. Kentucky will shoot. Oakland's best player comes on the bench. He's just like one of Kentucky's shooters. I think Kentucky puts 100 up on Oakland. Kentucky matches 13 against Oakland, my best bet. Wildcats, I know we're in Indiana. We anti-hillbillies, Wildcats, but hey, they're the team, I think. They're the team to be on.
I will see your SEC pick, David, and I will raise you Bruce Pearl and the Auburn Tigers.
There you go.
My best bet in round one, Auburn, I'm going to lay 12.5 against Yale. Yale needed a last-second shot to win the Ivy League championship, and defense travels. And say what you want about Bruce Pearl personally, but the dude coaches ball, and defense travels. I love Auburn. I'm laying 12.5 against Yale. That's my best bet in the first round. Gentlemen, I appreciate you. Best of luck, and may the odds be ever in your favor.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good luck to everybody.
Thank you.
All right, I've given you my best bet. I've given you an upset. And now, let's do the Degenerate Special.
It's time for Hammer's Degenerate Special.
I love this time of year. And the challenge with the Degenerate Special is, with the NCAA tournament, there really aren't many degenerate teams. Everybody here is there for a reason. They either won their conference championship or they're an at-large. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go next level degenerate on you and talk about first half unders, okay? Betting team totals just in the first half of games. Since 2018, all first half unders in the NCAA tournament first round, 57%. Since 2011, games with a 1 p.m. start Eastern time or earlier, first half unders are hitting at 62%. Last year, in round one games featuring a team seeded 4 through 8, okay? Any team that seeded 4 through 8 that had a game, that's 20 total games. First half unders went 9-1 on Thursday and 7-3 on Friday. That's an 80% success rate, okay? So here's what I'm looking at. I'm trying to combine all this information. I'm adding up all the data here. I'm looking for teams that are seeded 4 through 8 that have games that start around 1 p.m., give or take a few minutes, or earlier. This narrows it down to 3 games. Northwestern at FAU, Duquesne against BYU, or Michigan State against Mississippi State. We're going to go with Michigan State against Mississippi State first half under. Under 61 points first half. It's the very first game of the tournament. So you could be cashing your first winning ticket before most of the other games even tip off. That's next level degenerate. You're welcome, Indianapolis. Top stories next.
Congresswoman Sparks will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Sparks and learn a little more about her. Whoa. Have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmaker's workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Spartz was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes. Spartz called staff morons and idiots.
Get this. Victoria Spartz says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich.
I'm running for Congress.
And I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
This is the most exciting time of the year. And we want you to go all the way. Even if your team doesn't. March on, Indiana, in a Hubler quality pre-owned vehicle. Shop any of Hubler's 12 locations and choose from over 1,000 vehicles. Chevys, Fords, GMCs, Buicks, Nissans, Acuras, Mazdas, Hondas, and many more. All makes, all models, certified vehicles, luxury vehicles, even the hard-to-find ones. Every Hubler Q-certified vehicle is covered by a 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus a 128-point vehicle inspection and a free Carfax history report. Hubler's got you covered for 100,000 miles. Busted brackets not included. So what drives Indiana? DriveHubler.com. For over 1,000 vehicles, visit any of our 12 locations.
Hubler's got you covered.
Warranty on select models less than 9 years old.
Indiana Pathways for Aging helps Hoosier Medicaid members age 60 and over get support at no additional cost to live life their way.
Mom's Parkinson's is progressing, and Pathways provides in-home support so she can be with family every day.
Pathways coordinates Medicaid and Medicare services. I'm getting help with meals, personal care, and transportation.
One day, I might choose a nursing home, but today, I have options with Pathways.
Eligible members can select a plan now. Call 87-PATHWAY-4 or visit in.gov/pathways.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
Hey, this is Spencer Thompson at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus. If you missed the biggest outdoor furniture sale of the season at Thompson Furniture, then you're in luck. We've extended the sale now through April Fool's Day. No joke, the best outdoor furniture by Berlin Gardens in Pollywood is on sale. Little to no maintenance, lasts for decades, leave it outside all year long. Sale ends April Fool's Day only at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus.
Your local news coming up in 2 minutes after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis.
To invest in American, all American, all American.
Visiting an Intel plant in Arizona to highlight computer chip investments as an example of his agenda working. He has campaign stops this evening in Texas.
Joe Biden, through his actions, is violating the laws of the United States of America.
Governor Greg Abbott accusing the president of lying about needing Congress to act on border security as legal fights continue over the state's efforts to crack down on illegal immigration. Two more of the former sheriff's deputies who called themselves the Goon Squad are sent to prison in Mississippi for the racist torture of two black men last year.
The former Rankin County sheriff's deputies admitted breaking into a home in Braxton, Mississippi, and torturing two black men, shooting one of them in the mouth, following a complaint from a neighbor that the men were staying with a white woman. Former Deputy Christian Deadman receiving the longest sentence handed down so far, ordered to serve 40 years. Daniel Opdyke was sentenced to 17 and a half years in federal prison. Each had pled guilty to federal civil rights charges.
Fox's Jack Callahan. Opdyke crying in court today as he told the victims his actions haunt him and that he had turned into a monster that night. Two others were sentenced yesterday. A fifth former deputy and an ex-police officer will be sentenced tomorrow. An inmate and an accomplice remain on the loose after a shootout at an Idaho hospital overnight, where the inmate, Skyler Mead, was being treated for what police call self-injurious behavior. Boise Police Chief Ron Weiniger says corrections officers were preparing to transport Mead back to prison when the accomplice ambushed them and both got away in a car.
It appears to be a 2020 gray Honda Civic.
and that vehicle was seen fleeing from the scene.
Two corrections officers were shot and wounded by the suspect. A third was shot during a gunfight as responding officers arrived. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
He's charged for murder and they're closed for business. Sunny, 47 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. You've got a clear radar and a low of 24 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox from Moss Roofing. Here's what's trending at 5:02. Several charges filed, including one for murder for Nicholas Folk. He's accused of killing Timothy Brown during a shooting at Landsharks in Broad Ripple last Saturday.
You know, everybody's having a good time and, you know, just, you know, doing what you do at Landsharks. You're doing some dancing, you're having some drinks, visiting with your friends, just socializing and everything, and then hearing something like that is just, it's a drag.
Customer Ron Wyckoff, who tells Wish TV, he's bummed about the nightclub being closed. Five others were hurt in the shooting that started with an argument. Landsharks could have done a better job to keep their establishment safe, says IMPD's new police chief.
They were asked to monitor who they used to promote events, have the proper security at the door. Those type of things, they didn't follow those things, to my understanding.
Chris Bailey talking with WIBC's Tony Katz. Prosecutors filed a formal murder charge against Terry Davis Jr. after the 18-year-old was arrested for a murder on the east side last Friday. The victim was ID'd as Davis's brother, who died at the hospital. Davis was found by police about a mile away from where the shooting happened, hiding in the bed of a truck. A 1-year-old boy was shot in a hotel room in Whitestown, Ryan Hedrick reports.
The preliminary investigation is that this unfortunate incident was accidental.
That's Whitestown Police Captain John Yerkosh, who says the child's father's gun accidentally went off and that he's cooperating with police. Ryan Hedrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Two so-called Delphi Murders YouTubers have been banned from all future court proceedings.
I got in trouble because Noe started with me, and I got witnesses.
Rick Snay, he's one of the YouTubers who went live to talk about Monday's altercation. He was there to testify for the defense in the contempt hearing. Judge Fran Gall says both men violated the decorum order. An Indiana state senator passed away Wednesday, just 2 days after her announcement to spend more time with family. Wes Woodward reports.
Democrat Jean Breaux represented District 34, which includes parts of Marion County Center, Lawrence, Warren, and Washington Townships. Amid ongoing health issues, she missed the 2024 legislative session that ended Friday. Her statement issued Monday afternoon came after reports over the weekend that she was in hospice care. Breaux was first appointed to the Senate in 2006. Later that year, she won election to the Senate. Wes Woodward, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Traffic and weather in 60 seconds. Your time is 5:04.
Get ready for storm season because you know as well as I do, storms in Indiana can be fierce and they can come out of nowhere. So don't wait for a leak to have your roof inspected. Have peace of mind about your roof being able to handle any storm. Moss Roofing, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com provides free inspections and can spot potential issues before they turn into costly repairs. Whether you're looking for a siding replacement after a strong wind or a roof replacement after a hailstorm, Moss Roofing has options that fit any budget. Just ask Moss Roofing about their payment plans. No matter your situation, Moss Roofing has you covered with a job done right every single time. I love that. That's very funny. Contact Moss Roofing today, 317-747-3665. 317-747-3665. Tell them Tony Katz sent you. Moss Roofing, 747-3665. Or online at Moss, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com.
With traffic on the fives at 5:05, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at westbound 70 Hendricks County, stopped a couple of miles before State Road 39. It's a delay of about 5 miles long because of construction blocking the right lane. That's going on until Friday night at midnight. Looking at eastbound 465, stop and go traffic from Keystone Avenue to Allisonville Road. And just now finding out about this crash in the same area. It's westbound 465 going to Keystone Avenue. It's on the exit ramp. And the exit ramp is open. It's partially blocked. Northwest side, northbound 465, grinding from 86th Street to 865. Southbound 465 on the east side slows after Penn Pike to Washington Street. To downtown, southbound 65 stop and go from MLK to Meridian Penn. Eastbound 70 slow to downtown Holt Road to the south split. And a crash, Carmel, 146th Street at Hazeldale Parkway. Traffic sponsored by ExpressRoads.com. Make hiring easier with the workforce experts Let the people at Express Employment Professionals find you the right fit. Hiring is about people, not algorithms. Visit expresspros.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the wind slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Drew Nersutis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
My name is Nigel. Jason Hammer right over there. We'll go straight to the hotline and bring on a gentleman that's been on many extravagant vacations as a result of the money that I've spent at his establishments in my 20s and 30s. Rob Sabatini is the owner of the Broad Ripple Trifecta. That would be Rock Lobster, Mineshaft, and Average Joe's. Rob, how are you?
I'm really well. How are you guys doing today?
Doing excellent. Look, man, it couldn't have been an easy weekend for Broad Ripple and the Village Association and the bar owners there. There was a shooting at Land Sharks. An individual passed away as a result of that shooting. There has been an arrest made. Just your overall thoughts on what happened over the weekend.
Well, I believe the last time that I spoke to you guys was shortly after the three people had been shot and killed on Broad Ripple Avenue during the summer.
Yes.
And I would just like to say that that this particular incident is a whole different type of shooting than that was. In that one, there was a lot of fault that could be put to some of the practices that were going along with the construction and some of the city issues and things that they forced us to deal with in Broadville during that time.
You had those big fences up that kind of crowded everybody together.
Yeah, we had fences up, and there were a lot of businesses that were practicing pretty roughshod business practices. You know, that were bringing a lot of a bad crowd really to Broadville. So you can kind of fast forward from that, and I believe I talked to you guys shortly after. You know, since that point in time, all of the bars have worked together quite well. We've been meeting monthly, organized with Broad Ripple Village Association and IMPD, and every month we get together and talk about things that we can do, good and bad. You know, good and speak up on the bad things that are going on. And, you know, if you follow the news at all, since those shootings, there had been really no issues in Broad Ripple that really even made the news. But during the initial meeting, when we met way back in June, we all came to the conclusion that one of the best things we could do would be to police ourselves. Mm-hmm. As I stated back then, you know, we put in a 1 a.m. curfew that lasted all the way through July to help calm down the area and do whatever we needed to do. It was at a great loss of money to all of us to do that, but everybody persevered through that. We also, at that point in time, agreed on business practices unanimously, I might add, that we would all follow. We all agreed not to do outside promoters that marketed to bad clientele. We agreed not to do what they call day parties, which also usually markets to a pretty rough clientele. And everybody agreed to this, including Land Sharks. So you fast forward through, the street gets done. Business has never really popped back the way it should. But during that point in time, at some point in time, you know, Land Sharks decided that they would no longer follow the pledges that we had all made. They came to a meeting in February and basically were very disingenuous about the way that they were going to conduct their business in the future. They left out a lot of things they were doing and whatever. They'd been under the eye of IMPD, the Village Association, excise and things for quite a while. You know, one of my main reasons to want to talk to you guys is I just wanted to make sure that people knew that I am not associated, because they're so close to me. I've had times where people think that, you know, that I'm one of the people that is associated with land sharks, and that is not true. I don't condone the business practices that they've had over the years. I mean, they've been really a thorn in my side for many, many years. I had, you know, I guess predicting isn't the word, but right. You know, I had warned people of their activities. There were rumored other gunplay incidents prior to this or whatever. I would question the fact if they were actually wanding and using metal detectors on people.
Okay, so Rob, let me jump in here real quick, because that's the point I wanted to bring up. Just being devil's advocate here, and again, I haven't spoken to anybody at Landsharks or anything like that, but if they come out and say, listen, we were wanding, mistakes happened. This was tucked in some chick's bra. We didn't get that close. It was a simple mistake. It could have happened anywhere else. What would be your response to that?
Well, we wand people. We have for the better part of the last 3 years since COVID came in. I mean, if you're wanding people, I mean, you're not intrusive on them. I mean, you know, you don't touch anybody's body with a wand. You just wand it over them, and if there's a piece of metal, it goes off. You know, like I said, you know, they've been under scrutiny from IMPD and excise, you know, before. And I mean, like I said, I can't speak for fact that they want or don't want. I have worked on nights where I have observed that they don't. I mean, but I don't know. I can't say for certain whether they were or not that night.
And so, Rob, I think what the point of this conversation is, I think, is you're telling us that Broad Ripple is doing well, has been safe. I don't know that you necessarily like to call out another business. I know you've known the owners for a long time. But what you're saying is, look, this is not us. This is not the norm. There are certain business practices that we've put in place as a community of bars and restaurants that some people aren't following.
Yes, exactly what I'm saying. And I personally had called them out just at a March meeting in which they were not in attendance. But it's in the minutes. I've called them out for their hypocrisy and their disingenuous attitude toward our rules. And I mean, you know, you can go back over the years. And I mean, that business model, if you can go back to Tiki Bob's or Taps and Dolls or, the old patio back in the day or wherever, the old Peppers building, those business models are just really dangerous, and they just don't work. And I've been up here for 30 years, and I'm very, very familiar with how that, you know, with how that works.
So
you know?
What do you want people to know about the nightlife in Broad Ripple at this point?
Well, the thing I want to know is this was a Land Sharks incident. It's not reflective of Broad Ripple or the community or what we're trying to do here. You know, we want everybody to get along. The bars are united in what we want to do to keep our neighborhood safe and bring people back to Broad Ripple and have a nice, safe, happy experience. IMPD, we have a great new North District Commander, Matthew Thomas, who did a great job, and they were on the scene in seconds. You know, the BRVA has vowed to work to close violent establishments or whatever, and you can see how well that all worked, and you can tell by the fact that Landsharks was basically shut down within 12 hours of this incident. So, you know, moving forward, I just hope that everybody understands that Broadville's working really hard to be safe. I think that the Avenue is a much safer place now than it was a week ago. And I think looking forward, you know, we will be able to to move on from this, and Broad Ripple should be much safer. I think there's been a lot of lessons learned in the last year that will carry forth for Broad Ripple for a long, long time.
Longtime bar owner Rob Sabatini, Rock Lobster, Mineshaft, Average Joe's. Rob, thanks for the update, man, and good luck this weekend.
Okay, thank you.
Okay,
thank you, guys.
My man Matt Bear's got a look at the roads.
All right, Nigel, looking at westbound 70 stop traffic before and after State Road 39. Total delay running about 5 miles now as we have the right lane closed near Hazelwood Road. That's after State Road 39. Stop to stop and go is what we are doing right now. Really start to drag down when we hit 39. Eastbound 70 slow to downtown. It's Tibbs Avenue to the south split. Southbound 65 jams before MLK 221st and slow round west. On the east side, northbound 465 stop and go traffic after 70 up to East 56th Street and a crash on the northeast side, westbound 465 to Keystone Avenue. That off ramp is partially blocked. This crash is a mess, guys. I'm looking at it, and right now people are using the gore point, in other words, the right lane from the main part of westbound 465, then crossing over the gore point to make their exit. I would definitely find another way around. We are slow in those westbound lanes from Keystone back to Allisonville Road. Traffic sponsored by Discover. Discover wants everyone to feel special with live 24/7 customer service. Learn more at discover.com/credit card. Limitations apply. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
49 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Did you know that April is Foot Health Awareness Month? Hi, this is Phoebe, and at the Good Feet Store, we think every month you should be aware of your foot health. Your feet support everything you do. Why wouldn't you want to properly support your feet in return? Foot health starts with having great support in your shoes, and with a selection of over 300 different styles and sizes of arch supports, we can help you get back to wearing your nice dress shoes, stylish flats, or even sandals in comfort. Listen to Ava's real Good Feet story.
I love shoes. You find them in the store, you know? They, like, call you, but they hurt. The best ones hurt the worst. And you're walking around going, I don't want anyone to know that I'm not happy. Stuck in the arch supports, and I felt so much better. I'd say Good Feet help with all of my great shoes. They turned out to be something that actually works for me. My name is Ava, and that's my Good Feet story.
Don't overlook your feet. Make sure they get the care and attention they need so they can keep supporting you. Find the Good Feet store nearest you at goodfeet.com. We look forward to helping you find better foot health.
Hey, I'm going to be a Window Nation customer for life. I love the job they did on my home. Who wouldn't want to be a Window Nation customer if you're looking for new windows? Buy two windows, get two free, plus zero down, zero interest, zero payments for 24 months. And you don't have to take my word for it. Here's what Katie had to say, Window Nation customer. Jason came out and did our quote for all of our windows in our home and was very thorough. He was incredibly knowledgeable as he told us his recommendations and worked with us on what we wanted. He also price matched with us, so we knew we were getting a great deal, but also a great product. Very professional, very helpful.
With this deal, there's no excuse for you not to be a Window Nation customer if you're looking for new windows. Buy two, get two for free. And if that's not enough, pay nothing with no interest for 2 full years. If you don't believe me, call them yourself. They'll answer any question you have. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com. But you have to tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
The floodgates are about to open in Indiana as spring approaches. Do you know if your sump pump is working properly? During the month of March, my friends at Hope Plumbing are offering a free sump pump with the purchase of a battery backup. A sump pump is vital to protecting your home from heavy rains and rising waters that do nothing but leave behind damage in your home. Call Hope Plumbing today at 641-HOPE or visit them online at hopeplumbing.com for a free sump pump with the purchase of a battery backup.
It's Kubota Orange Days. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And now, through June 30th, get 0% APR for 84 months and up to $2,500 off BX23S tractors. See the details at KubotaOrangeDays.com.
Stop by McAllister Machinery in Fishers and Indianapolis to see their full line of Kubota, or visit them online at McAllisterKubota.com.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Inside Indiana Business Radio, the news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:32 a.m. and 5:56 p.m. on WIBC.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
Tune in Saturdays 9 to 1 for the Home and Garden Show for advice and fun. Brought to you by Michalis. Water, storms, fire, and wet basements. Life happens. Michalis happens to help you through it.
Okay, let's begin. Are you really okay with this?
Are you okay? Everything's gonna be okay.
Are you okay? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I'm pretty f***ing far from okay.
Whoa. Are you okay with this? On the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Oh, yeah. Well, authorities in upstate New York have seized an 11-foot alligator from a man's house.
Oh!
After determining he was keeping the reptile illegally. Are you okay with this?
Did you say an 11-foot alligator?
11-foot alligator. Yeah, I mean, we talked about this. I don't know if you saw it on which TV. I saw a picture of this thing. It's huge. Huge.
No, I'm not okay with this. I don't care if it's a service animal. I don't care if it's there to help somebody that's blind or maybe the alligator's got magical powers. I don't know. All I know is I don't want to live next door to the crazy SOB that has an 11-foot alligator. And my favorite word in this story is he was keeping the reptile illegally. Like, hold I don't on. Care if he's keeping it legally. I don't care. I don't want to live next door to that.
He was keeping it legally. And that's where I kind of have a problem with this story. He had a license. He built an indoor pool for this alligator. This alligator's 30 years old. It's blind. It's got, like, spinal problems.
I was just joking. The alligator's actually blind?
The alligator is blind. And the guy built a pool. He says it's docile. It is not aggressive. He loves it.
Oh, bull crap. And
again, he had a license, but the bureaucrats from whatever commission that, you know, decides whether or not you're allowed, you know, to renew, they did not renew his license for whatever reason.
I can't believe I'm going to say this. I can't believe these words are coming out of my mouth. Thank God for the government in New York, because I don't care if he's keeping this blind gator legally or illegally, or if he's built a pond for it, or if he spoons with it at night. I don't care. I don't want my family living next door to an 11-foot blind alligator. Yeah. I think that's honestly even worse. Yeah. Like, oh, damn, where did one of my kids go? Oh, I'm sorry, my alligator thought you were food. He is blind. That sucks. No, I'm not okay with this.
A man in Nevada had more than 100 pounds of sliced bread dumped on his property last week. And he had no idea where it came from. Here is Kurt Dennis talking about the bread being dumped at his funeral casket supplies business.
I can't get rid of it. I don't know how to get rid of it. It's just too much. And they just kind of chuckled under their breath. And it's like, oh, my gosh, you know, why would that happen? They were thinking that I only talked about a little bit of bread, and I told them how much it was. And it was just, they just kind of laughed. Now, I know I can't get a hold of anybody, and I don't know what to tell you. And that was what Smith's rep told me.
Apparently a frustrated truck driver that didn't want to go through the process of returning his delivery to the proper spot. Hammer dropped the bread off randomly at this property. Are you okay with this?
No, I'm not. But unfortunately, this kind of stuff happens. Now, if you're a fan of the TV show Sopranos, there was an episode in The Sopranos once where a bunch of garbage got dropped off in front of this guy's, like, store. Okay. And he was complaining and yelling, but ultimately, the city said it was his responsibility to pick it up.
Doesn't that suck?
And if you look at the ordinance of the city here, this Nevada city, quote, "It is the responsibility of the property owner to clean up as it happened on their property." This stinks. So you could have a rogue garbage guy that, Does it like you? Does it like your politics? Does it like your business? Just dump all this trash off. And the city was like, well, sucks to be you. Better get out there with a dustpan Skippy and pick it up. That's awful.
If there was, here, a little bit more there. If there was evidence that another party is responsible, then it could be reported to the city. If the property owner does not clean it, they would be in violation of city code. Yeah, that's...
Yeah, I'm sure the city's going to run right over there and clean it up when they can just say, eh, it's on your property. It's really a big mess. Good luck.
Can't even fill potholes. They're not going to go get... I saw footage of this. It was hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of bags of bread.
I mean, it could have been worse. It could have been like rotten fish or sure. fish guts or, you know, dead animal carcass or something like that. It could have been worse.
Where do you want to go here? We probably got time for one more. Do you want to do the expensive cat, or do you want to do the underage drinking and drugs sign?
Well, let's do underage drinking and drugs.
A Florida man was arrested for ramming an SUV into a zero-tolerance underage drinking and drugs sign. Alonzo was charged with criminal mischief and resisting arrest. Here is some audio from some onlookers.
Holy cow, he's doing it again.
The policeman's probably going to have to, like, block him in there.
How?
I don't know.
Watch, he's going to really go this time. Oh, my Lord, what is he doing? Zero tolerance for drugs and alcohol.
Yeah, what is he doing?
Well, he squared up again.
Are you okay with this?
So it's my understanding that if you're born in the state of Florida with the name of Alonzo... immediately you have a suspended license. Like, they just take care of it when you're young because they know what's going to happen when you get older. Living in Florida with the name of Alonzo, you're going to have your license suspended
now,
at some point.
His full name is Alonzo Dwayne Prim.
I don't care if it was Alonzo Morning. That's a name that just says, hey, you're probably going to be involved now, in some shenanigans.
Come on.
And you know what, though? I do feel kind of bad because you see all these signs, you know, no to drugs, do all these things. When we were kids, do you remember the DARE against drugs and alcohol pledge? Did you sign the DARE pledge when you were a kid?
I don't remember, maybe. Yeah, possibly. What did DARE stand for? Does anybody know what DARE stands for?
Something, drugs and resistance to, I don't know, eating eggs. I have no idea. But it was supposed to be this anti-drug, anti-alcohol thing, and just like Just Say No or the War on Drugs.
Drug abuse resistance education.
I was close. And
you said eggs.
I was close. I signed it when I was a kid. Didn't really mean a damn thing, but I signed it. And like, if there's ever a Hammer and Nigel movie, like an origin story, like me signing that and you see the big fat drunk bastard that I am now, and the fact that you can't remember doing it or you were probably not at school that day, the same way you're never at work, that's the origin story for the Hammer and Nigel Show movie. All right, Tony Kennett, the Tonus, he's coming up next. Right now, Harrison Silcox has the news.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level. The go.
Putting some of the blame on the business. 48 degrees and mostly sunny in downtown Indianapolis. You've got a clear radar. Low of 24 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 529. Ensuring Indianapolis is a safer place to live involves more than just the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says the recent shooting at the nightclub Landsharks is a prime example.
But in this particular case in Broad Ripple, you had an establishment who was not working with the community up there. They established some things last year, some community expectations. This establishment wasn't meeting those community expectations.
Bailey talking with WIBC's Tony Katz. The Indiana Alcohol and Tobacco Commission has suspended Landsharks' liquor license. Monday's Delphi murders hearing had an order in place to keep everyone civil. Donnie Burgess reports there were a couple people who didn't get the memo.
Rick Snay and David Noe are so-called YouTubers who cover the Delphi murders case. It's unclear what perspective they actually offer, but that appears to be cause for a feud between the two. They got into an argument at the Allen County Courthouse Monday.
Noe stalked me into a stairway and tried to start with me. I got right up nose to nose with the little son of a
Snay during a YouTube live video. Both men are now banned from all future court proceedings. They'll have to cover the case from the living room. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell offers up the best way to send help to Ukraine.
What I've said repeatedly is we're running out of time. And the best way to get Ukraine the help they need is for the House to pass the Senate bill.
House Speaker Mike Johnson and Senate Democrats have been at odds over national security funding legislation that's supposed to send some military help to Ukraine, plus funding for Taiwan and humanitarian aid in Gaza. The Federal Reserve keeping interest rates unchanged.
Markets believe we will achieve that goal, and they should believe that, because that's what will happen over time. But we stress over time.
Fed Reserve Chair Jerome Powell said the policy rate is likely at its peak. He reminded that the Fed is still committed to its 2% inflation goal. With traffic at 531, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at the northeast side, it is a crash on the exit from westbound 465 to Keystone Avenue, and it just moved out of the interstate onto the shoulder. So it's still there, but it's not blocking any of the exit lanes anymore, I am told. Traffic is slow back to Allisonville Road. Still congested, still kind of a mess. Please be safe on your exit, please. And a crash downtown. It is southbound 65 at Meridian Penn between West and Meridian Penn. Left lane is closed down. Traffic is stop and go back to MLK. Eastbound 70 dragging into downtown from Holt Road to the south split. Hendricks County westbound 70 is a zoo from John Pine to Hazelwood. That's about a 6-mile delay before and after State Road 39. If you pass 267, you'll be in it. Construction delay blocking the right lane until late Friday night. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the winds slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Drew Narsutis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Nigel Show. My name is Nigel. That's Jason Hammer. We'll go straight to the hotline and bring on Tony Kennett, host of the Tony Kennett Cast, weeknights right after our show on 93 WIBC. He's also an investigative reporter for the Daily Signal. You can find his work at dailysignal.com. Tony, let's just go through some of these headlines I'm seeing right now here on Daily Signal. Exclusive. Biden presides over a record-breaking 11 embassy evacuations.
11. 11.
That's embarrassing. What exactly is going on here?
So this report actually started after I saw something on Twitter in which people were openly asking, well, how many, you know, with Haiti being an absolute mess and secretly flying out staff in the middle of the night and even having to evacuate our own Marines in the Haitian embassy, you know, what's the total? And someone had suggested it was 7, and I looked and found that was to be true. And I dug further and actually looked at all of the State Department ordered partial or full evacuations since Biden took office. And the number is kind of 11, but really 14. So it's 11 different countries and 14 total if you count Haiti, you know, the country Biden promised to settle down when he got elected. They've been evacuated once per year since he came into office.
So what does all this mean then exactly? Because, you know, I saw Niger was on there. Is just went on the list. Haiti's all these places have been messes for a long time. Is it a function of the country or is it a function of the leader of our nation?
So we need to make this very clear. The embassy of the United States in each of these countries is U.S. territory. It is a little dot in that country that solely belongs to the U.S. I don't care whatever country it is, unless they are at open war with the United States, they do not have right to that land. If there's a civil war in Chad or Niger or whatever, by the way, there are civil wars raging in like 30 countries around the globe. A lot of people ignore the U.S. embassy because, again, that's the United States place. That's not the ownership of that country. And what the State Department has screwed up doing is they have basically ignored serious warning signs in some of these places to keep Americans safe. And then Biden pulls them out in the middle of the night and they end up leaving hundreds of Americans stranded And the people in those countries, knowing there's not going to be any retaliation from the Americans for killing Americans, end up killing or kidnapping Americans, as we found out in Nigeria and Afghanistan.
And are there still Americans in Haiti as we speak, a place where their government has just completely collapsed?
So Haiti is a bit of a different situation. Yes, there are close to 1,000 Americans that are stranded in Haiti. Oof. However, and I'll put the asterisk here, the State Department has warned Americans to get out of Haiti for some time. Okay. However, there are countries on that list in which the Biden administration did not issue any warnings. In fact, the State Department was caught lying to media about Americans being kidnapped when they should have been issuing like a all Americans need to leave right now kind of warning.
Well, Tony, this is such a bizarre twist of what's happening, because I can remember just like it was yesterday when a certain president called countries like Haiti and the conditions that they have blank holes, and everybody lost their mind because of the salty language. And lo and behold, fast forward to today, they are indeed blank hole countries. And yet nobody wants to bring up the fact that, you know, the orange guy said this was going to happen years ago.
This is the part that I think is great. There's a left-wing journalist out there today who is griping about my article, you know, the ending and why. And he says, well, it's not Biden's fault that a lot of the world right now is in a mess, and maybe we don't need embassy presences endangering Americans in those places. Yet, like you said, Hammer, just a few years ago when Trump said that several African countries and Ecuador and Haiti El Salvador. When those countries had significant problems, maybe we shouldn't just be accepting immigrants by the boatload. All of a sudden, that was, you know, totally out of sorts. That was unacceptable.
Right.
It seems, as usual, the goalposts are continuously being shifted.
Nobody wanted to talk about why Donald Trump and many others felt these countries deserve that title.
Right.
They just wanted to talk about the salty language that the president used. How about you actually focus on why people feel that way, so maybe situations like now wouldn't happen?
And again, the demographic in the United States who is the most against illegal immigration is Hispanic Americans. Hispanic Americans despise illegal immigration. And what the Biden administration should be doing is listening to them during this election season. But instead, he went to a Mexican restaurant in Phoenix and announced Latinos con Biden Harris, which everyone rightly called a pandering, nonsensical mess.
Tony Kennett of the Daily Signal joining us. Did I see you get cited on Sean Hannity's program? Was that last night?
I did, and that was really weird because he brought on Victor David Hansen, who I think is like the king of foreign policy, to discuss congressmen actually lecturing the State Department on my article. I got to be honest with you guys, that was a really cool moment. I was really honored.
And again, not to do a victory lap here, but this radio station, and again, I'm so proud of the team that we've assembled here. If you think about the cast and crew we've got, you know, Tony Kennett's being cited on one of, if not the highest rated cable news program in the country, Sean Hannity's program last night, our program in the afternoon, regularly number one in multiple demos, Kendall and Casey nominated for an award this past year, Tony Katz, you see him on, you know, national news from time to time, doing two shows here.
Seen him on.
I am so proud of the crew that we have here, man. Like, I love this team that we got.
Really, that's the thing that I keep coming back to is, again, when I can say this because, you know, I grew up as a small child. Actually, maybe I should question, as a small child listening to Bob and Tom, I consider you guys genuinely the spiritual successor to the great Bob and Tom. And there's a reason that people in Indiana consistently turn towards what WIBC is churning out. And I got to tell you guys, I mean, it's a joy to get to work here and to argue with some of you occasionally because – I know that we're trying to make things better for the common Hoosier. It's good stuff.
Tony Kennett, host of the Tony Kennett Cast and investigative reporter for Daily Signal here on the Hammer and Nigel show. Let's turn our attention to this southern border. So, like yesterday, it was breaking news. The Supreme Court comes out and says, yeah, Texas is allowed to enforce the law there at the border. And now I wake up this morning and I guess it's not that way anymore. Like the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals says, no, we're going to put a hold on that. What's going on?
So the Supreme Court issued a ruling that the Biden administration can't simply halt Texas enforcing the law just because they have filed an appeal to the Fifth Circuit. So the Fifth Circuit has not yet ruled whether Texas can enforce the bill which allows them to arrest and deport illegal aliens operating within the state of Texas. I think that probably more than this, because this is going to go back and forth a little bit more, and we all know Greg Abbott's just going to do what he wants at the end anyway, thank God. The better story here is the response from Mexican President Obrador. Have you guys seen that?
Oh, yeah. He's not going to let him back in.
How? Right. He can't even stop people from going through his country. The man's usually on his knees to the Sinaloa cartel. Well, what's he going to do? Grow some maize? Get out of here.
And on the topic of immigration, you've got a little breaking news story. Can we talk about this that you're putting out, Tony?
Yeah, if it's not out yet, it will be. And that is the Heritage Oversight Project, which is who I coordinate a lot of my Freedom of Information Act requests through. We looked into James Madison High School in New York City. You know, the high school that threw a bunch of New York City students out so they could house 2,000 migrants in for the day.
Yes.
And this school, as we looked back and found out, this district basically coordinated this migrant housing situation, this illegal immigrant housing situation, for like 5, 6, 7 hours before they ever spoke to parents about it. And so the school later tried to say, well, we included parents from the very beginning. That was a lie. And we found as such, and we're actually publishing those emails and documents up on the Daily Signal.
Unbelievable.
What is coming up on the amazing Tony Kinnett cast tonight?
Oh, man, we've got Guy Relford calling in because Chicago is suing Glock for pistols. And then also we've got Bill Whittle from the Daily Wire. We're talking about, he's got a new Cold War series coming out. It's going to be really cool.
The Tony Kinnett cast, right after our program, Monday through Friday at 7 o'clock. Also, check out his work at the Daily Signal on social media at The Tonus. Tonus, have a good one, buddy.
Thanks, guys.
All right, Nige, we've got one more pair of Kenny Chesney concert tickets to give away. When the Sun Goes Down tour, it's coming to Indy.
Cool.
Ruoff Music Center, caller number 9. You get to play the game. 239-9393. That's 239-9393. Your chance to win the Kenny Chesney tickets next.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Definitely no other real estate agent I'd trust to not only sell my house, but find me another house to live in. His name is Mark Deedle. He's a real estate expert. Don't take my word for it. Greg in Franklin, here's what he had to say. My tenant moved out of my investment property, and I was done, and I was ready to sell. I heard about Mark on the radio, and everything they say is true. In 15 days on the market, I had a cash offer, and it was done. Selling with Mark Deedle was fast, easy, and profitable.
Only Mark Deedle offers the guarantee. This is what separates Mark Deedle from everybody else. Mark Deedle guarantees your home sold at a mutually agreed upon price and deadline, or he will buy it. You pick the move date, no long-term contracts. Mark Deedle makes it easy. Call him today. 317-755-4232 or go to markdeedle.com. That's Mark D-I-E-T-E-L, markdeedle.com.
Kate here from Baths R Us with the three biggest problems people always have with bathroom remodelers and how Baths R Us overcomes them all. First, it takes too long. Everyone's heard the horror stories of jobs that drag on for weeks or months. But at Baths R Us, we're in and out in 2 or 3 days and it looks stunning. Problem number two, the final bill is more than the original estimate. Baths R Us doesn't give estimates. We give ironclad quotes. We remodel over 1,500 bathrooms a year. You can be confident there will be no last-minute surprises. And problem number three, they don't do the job right. Baths R Us only hires master craftsmen who are trained and certified and who use the highest quality materials. That's why we're proud to offer our no-regrets promise, your personal guarantee that you'll love your new bathroom. Call right now and get $1,500 off plus low to no monthly payments. Our number is 317-886-1761 or online at bathsrus.com. That's bathsrus.com.
Hi, this is Denny Smith. When it comes to your well, preventive maintenance is the key to safe and reliable water. Now's a great time to upgrade your equipment, and C&J is offering progressive discounts so you can upgrade your water system. Invest in one item, it's $250 off. Two items, $500 off. And invest in three items, you'll get $750 off. C&J is also offering a free water analysis and discounted bacteria test. It's the best deal of the year. Call C&J at 317-852-WELL or cjforwater.com.
Woodard Emhart, Henry Reeves, and Wagner. Over 140 years specializing exclusively in patent, trademark, trade secret, and copyright law and litigation. On the web at uspatent.com.
Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee, only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000, 999-9000.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Still plenty of time to vote in Meltdown Madness, presented by Window Nation. It's pinned to our Twitter, at Hammer and Nigel. We've got Jim Mora, playoffs against Bob Knight's iconic locker room rant. Get your votes in right now. Winner goes to the Final Four, Matt Bear.
All right, Hammer Crash, clear downtown, southbound 65 at Meridian Penn. Traffic still stop and go back to 29th Street. And crash clear, westbound 465 to Keystone Avenue. The crash on the exit ramp, not bothering us anymore. And Lawrence, northbound 465, stop and go before Penn Pike up to 71st. Eastbound 70, slow to downtown, hard and to the south split. Huge delay in Hendricks County, westbound 70, about 5.5 miles now, and it stretches before and after State Road 39. If you pass 267, you're in it. This is because of construction blocking the right lane, and that's scheduled to go on until late Friday night. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
50 degrees at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. And let's play Kenny, Benny, or Denny.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Last pair of tickets to go see Kenny Chesney. Ruoff Music Center, Thursday, June 20th, When the Sun Goes Down tour. Mitch happened to be caller number 9. Mitch, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel Show. How are you?
Thank you. Good, doing good.
All right, you know the game, right? We're going to play Kenny, Benny, or Denny, and this is how it works. I'm going to give you a fact about someone. It will either be a fact about Kenny Chesney, British comedian, the late, great Benny Hill, or from the Home and Garden Show, Denny Smith. You get 2 out of 3, and we're going to give you the tickets, okay?
Okay.
Number one, had a hit single called She Thinks My Tractor Sexy. Kenny, Benny, or Denny?
That would be Kenny.
That would be Kenny. All right. Here we go. Get this one right. We're going to throw a little bit of a party. And there's a little audio clue on this one as well. Kenny, Benny, or Denny would use the song Yakety Sax to end his TV shows. Who you got, Mitch?
That would be Benny.
Yes, that would be Benny Hill. damn right. You got it right. Let's go. Two tickets to Ruoff Music Center. It's Thursday, June 20th, when the Sun Goes Down tour with Kenny Chesney. Mitch, you know the drill. You won the tickets. So whoever is going to that show with you, they're the designated driver, and you get the drink.
All righty.
Stay on the line, and our crew will take care of you, okay? All right. Now, that's the last pair of those tickets we have to give away. I think Nige, the next couple of days, might have some other prizes for you guys. I'm out the next couple of days. I'm doing degenerate stuff. But Nige might have a little something for you guys. I think Spanglish and Nige will hook you up tomorrow. In the meantime, let's do a quick round of booze news.
You set them up and I'll knock them back, Lloyd. One by one.
We are going to read booze news because it's really fun.
Once it hits your lips, it's so good.
Hammer Nigel presents booze news, booze news.
Yeah. Time for booze news.
So, keeping it in the world of country music, Lainey Wilson. Just a tremendously fast-rising star in the world of country music and famous for her iconic backside, if you want to call it that. She kept the tradition of going to Australia and having a shooey. Now, if you don't know what a shooey is, it's where you drink beer out of a boot. Here she is taking her shooey.
You ready for this? But I'm dang excited about it. You ready, brother? Let's go. Come on. Holler and swallow.
So a shooey is a thing. If you go down to Australia, don't be grossed out by it. Just go with the flow. If somebody pours you a beer in a shoe, unless it's been on the foot of like Bernie Sanders or something, go ahead and just drink it. All right. Don't go anywhere. Top stories next.
When do you plan to file for Social Security? Be careful here because you could set off a chain reaction of events with your taxes, IRA, and 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your Medicare premiums. And this could needlessly cost you a small fortune. Hey, it's Hammer and Nigel. Learn how you could avoid this with a free customized Social Security analysis from Bill Demery, your retirement guy, right here in Indy.
So if you've saved more than $200,000 for retirement and have not yet filed for Social Security, you've got to call Bill Demery right now. He'll give you a free analysis. Free. But you got to call 317-648-5120. 317-648-5120. Social Security, it's complicated, but Bill Demery will make it make sense for you. I've met with Bill. He's the best. 317-648-5120. 5120, Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Two rock legacies celebrate two iconic albums. Stone Temple Pilots. And live. September 15th, Ruoff Music Center. Special guest, Soul Asylum. The 30th anniversary of Purple and Throwing Copper, the Jubilee Tour. Reserved seats on sale Friday morning at 10 at LiveNation.com. Part of the Coors Light Concert Series.
I'm a grandson, a son. I'm an employee and a mentor. I'm a father to two beautiful kids and a husband to an amazing wife. And I have a substance use disorder. In other words, I'm living in recovery with an addiction. And now that you know, will you let it change how you see me? It's okay to see my addiction, but I want you to know it's people choosing to see me as a person that changed my life.
See the person, not just their disease. Learn more at seebeyondtheaddiction.org.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI.
If you have breathing triangle issues like compromised nasal breathing and sleep, snoring, or even sleep apnea issues, a call to Advent makes sense because breathing well will help you live better.
AdventKnows.com. Indy's biggest party is back.
Miller Lite Carb Day, Friday, May 24th, featuring George Thorogood and the Destroyers. With special guest, Gin Blossoms. Miller Lite Carb Day, May 24th at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Concert, pit, and VIP tickets on sale now at IMS.com.
Your one blood donation can help save the lives of up to three people. Give blood through the American Red Cross to help hospital patients. Visit redcrossblood.org today.
Tony Katz.
The cities have failed, become too difficult. Whether it be Chicago or San Francisco or New York or Indianapolis, they are connected by their progressive politics, and their progressive politics make things too difficult. It does not take a brain surgeon. It does not take any level of skill to note the connectivity. Just admit it.
Tony Katz, mornings 6 to 9 on 93 WIPC and WIPC.com.
This is Inside Indiana Business Radio. I'm Kate Sharon. Indiana is on a short list of six states being considered to be part of a national network of bioindustrial manufacturing pilot facilities. BioMade, a manufacturing innovation institute sponsored by the U.S. Department of Defense, is developing the facilities as a means to provide startups and small companies with access to intermediate equipment to validate and scale up their biomanufacturing processes before moving on to develop their own facilities. Jack Starr, Chief Manufacturing Officer for BioMade, said Indiana presented multiple benefits for such a facility.
For our facilities to be successful, we need a couple of things. We need a great partner at or near the site. We need a good business environment, which can manage like the zoning and the permits. And we need co-investment from state and local.
BioMade says the country faces a foundational gap in domestic pilot and intermediate scale biomanufacturing facilities. Michigan-based manufacturing company Dexco Global Incorporated has acquired the City Spring Group of companies headquartered in Edmonton, Alberta. Financial details were not disclosed, but Dexco said the companies will become part of its Elkhart-based subsidiary, Dexter Axle Co., LLC. From the number one source for Indiana business news, this is Inside Indiana Business Radio.
At Indiana University, we're undaunted by challenge. We take the lead. We don't follow the crowd. Embracing the future with creativity and bravery. Unapologetically optimistic. Equipped with the knowledge and intention to change the world. Because bold is who we are. 9 campuses, 1 purpose. Creating tomorrow, today. Indiana University. Bring on tomorrow. Join us at iu.edu.
An Indianapolis-based tech company is included among this year's most innovative companies from Fast Company magazine. Brew Logics, which has created a platform of digital tools for craft beverage makers, is ranked 9th in the business services category. ISDA Director Don Lamb is this week's guest on the Business and Beyond podcast with Gary Dick, presented by PNC, a weekly conversation with high-profile Hoosiers in business, sports, entertainment, and beyond, available now from your favorite podcast provider. I'm Kate Sharon for 93.1 WIBC.
Coming up in 2 minutes, IMPD's police chief says land sharks could have done something to prevent a shooting last weekend. A 1-year-old was accidentally shot by his father, and why today's strong winds provide a reason for you to be careful. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. Mostly clear skies downtown with temperatures in the upper 40s. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 6 o'clock.
Surprises from the Fed. I'm Lisa Lacera, Fox News. The Federal Reserve keeping interest rates steady.
The central bank will be keeping its benchmark interest rate unchanged for the fifth straight time, Fed Chair Jerome Powell.
The committee decided at today's meeting to maintain the target range for the federal funds rate at 5.25% to 5.5%.
The Fed still foresees 3 rate cuts this year, despite hotter than anticipated inflation in recent months. Powell adds,
inflation has eased substantially while the labor market has remained strong. And that is very good news. But inflation is still too high. Ongoing progress in bringing it down is not assured. and the path forward is uncertain.
As a result, the Fed is forecasting 3 rate cuts occurring in 2025, which is down from 4 from their December projections.
Fox's Hillary Barsky. Stocks rallied after the decision from the Fed. The Dow gained 401. The NASDAQ added 202. The S&P plus 46. President Biden continues his swing through the Sun Belt, now on his way to Texas after a stop in Arizona, telling supporters that an Intel plan, his economic plan, is working.
My predecessor can let the future be built in China and other countries, not America, because it may be cheaper for those investing. Folks, I promise to be the president of all Americans, whether you voted for me or didn't vote for me.
And he said today's investment helps all Americans, adding, we're not leaving anyone behind. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis sending a plane to Haiti to rescue Americans as gang violence there heats up.
We're committed to rescuing Floridians from this situation. It's a bad situation.
Armed gangs have launched new attacks in the suburbs of the capital of Port-au-Prince. The State Department says it's completed its first evacuation of Americans from Port-au-Prince. New data from the FBI shows overall violent crime in the U.S. dropped again last year, continuing a downward trend after an uptick during the pandemic. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
Putting some of the blame on the business. 48 degrees, sunny in downtown Indianapolis. All clear under radar, low of 24 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox for Moss Roofing. Here's what's trending at 6:02. IMPD Chief Chris Bailey says the Broad Ripple nightclub, where a man was shot and killed, failed to create a safe environment.
They were asked to. They were asked to monitor who they used to promote events, have the proper security at the door. Those type of things, they didn't follow those things, to my understanding.
Bailey talking with WIBC's Tony Katz. 5 other people were hurt in the shooting. Landsharks has had their liquor license suspended, and they may have to close for good. A 1-year-old boy was accidentally shot at a Whitestown hotel room by his father. Police Captain John Yurkosh says detectives are looking into what happened.
If at all there are applicable charges, I know that they are working in cooperation with the family.
The child is in the hospital. Monday's Delphi murders hearing had an order in place to keep everyone civil. Donnie Burgess reports there were 2 people who didn't get the memo.
Rick Snay and David Noe are so-called YouTubers who cover the Delphi murders case. It's unclear what perspective they actually offer, but that appears to be cause for a feud between the two. They got into an argument at the Allen County Courthouse Monday.
Noe stalked me into a stairway and tried to get, you know, tried to start with me. I got right up nose to nose with the little son of a
Snay during a YouTube Live video. Both men are now banned from all future court proceedings. They'll have to cover the case from the living room. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
High wind gusts and no rain could bring about fires if you're not careful. Casey Fuson with the National Weather Service in Indianapolis discussed what has her concerned.
Just some dry ground out there, so it's really conducive for any small fire that might be started, say from like a discarded cigarette butt, that could then create a small fire along the sides of roads.
She's most concerned about central and southern Indiana. You're paying an average of $3.51 for a gallon of gas today, says AAA. That's up 22 cents from last week and the exact same as the national average. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather at 6:04.
With the weather changing, March is a critical time to check your home's windows. If yours are cracked or leaking and won't open or stay open, then it's time to call the pros at Window Nation. Right now, for every 2 windows you buy, you'll get 2 windows free. There's no limit to how much you could save. Plus, you could save even more with zero down, zero interest, and zero payments for 24 months. Window Nation's windows come with a lifetime warranty and can be installed in 1 day or less.
With proven quality service, it's no wonder thousands of homeowners have trusted Window Nation for their homes. And you can too. If your old windows and high energy costs from this past winter are cutting deep into your finances, don't miss out. With this unlimited deal, buy 2, get 2 free, plus zero down, zero interest, and no payments for 24 months. You can't afford to wait. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com. Schedule your free in-home estimate.
With traffic on the 5s at 6:05, here's Matt Baer.
Still a long delay in Hendricks County. Harrison, it's westbound at 70 running before and after State Road 39. So the delay is about 5.5 miles right now. as we take a look at it, with the right lane blocked with construction. That's going on until late Friday night. The construction zone is eastbound 465, stop and go Keystone Avenue to Allisonville Road. Northbound 465, Lawrence slows at East 56 to 71st. Southbound 65, slow 21st to Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Things start to get a little cloudy as we make our way overnight into Thursday morning. Overnight, we'll also see the wind slow down and temperatures drop to about 25 degrees by Thursday morning. Thursday looks to be mostly cloudy. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Renner Sudis for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
My name is Nigel. That's Jason Hammer right over there. Let's go through these charges one more time that have officially been filed against the Broad Ripple shooter, the guy that opened fire in land sharks, killing one, injuring several others. There's one count of murder, three counts of aggravated battery, two counts of battery with a deadly weapon, and then it's this last one that has my eyebrows raised. One count of possession of a firearm by a serious violent felon. It's that last one that raises a few questions, Hammer.
Serious violent felon, meaning you are not legally allowed to possess a firearm. Okay, fine. I understand. Bad guys will find ways to be bad guys.
Yes.
But the questions that I have are for the prosecutor, Ryan Mears, the prosecutor's office, and some of the judges in Marion County. So what is this serious violent felony that this guy was previously convicted for? And how much time did he do? And also, what was the basis of this sweetheart plea deal that the prosecutor, Ryan Mears, and this judge had? Why did the judge approve it? These are all fair questions, because could this have been avoided?
That's the big question. Could this thing have been prevented? Was the shooting preventable if there wasn't some sort of sweetheart plea deal for a previous conviction?
And listen, we're not talking about misdemeanors here. Serious violent felon. Those are three pretty big words right there. And it happens time and time again here in Indianapolis, where the prosecutor is more concerned about finding the root cause than locking up trash and keeping them off the streets. Now, I understand you can't lock up everybody. We've heard Boss Hogsett in those rare moments when he's been sober say that over and over again. Well, we can't lock up everybody. Okay, fine. Let's figure something out.
I don't want to lock up everybody.
Right. Let's figure something out. Let's maybe make a deal. I'm open to deals. I'm open to plea deals for folks that are not injuring, hurting, or killing people. If it's a victimless crime, let's have a conversation. But serious violent felons, threats to society, need to be locked up. And I'm sorry, I'm all for jail reform and all this other stuff that makes people feel good, but sometime you just have to lock up a rotten bastard for a long time.
So again, the question remains, what is the serious violent felony? Because one of the charges from the guy that opened fire in land sharks, one count of possession of a firearm by a serious violent felon. Well, what was that previous serious violent felony? And how much time did he do? And what was the basis of the sweetheart plea deal, Mears, and why did the judge approve it?
And again, sometimes it feels like I'm just talking into a mirror, though, because 60% of the vote, 60% of voters in Central Indy hitched their wagon to Ryan Mears for a couple more years the last time he was up for election against a good candidate in Cindy Carrasco.
Did you see any of that surveillance video from the shooting?
I did. And what I saw was the suspect and a female walk in together. He reaches down into her bra and pulls out the gun. And then a few minutes go by, And it turns out that was the gun that was fired inside of Landsharks.
So wait, they got through security, according to reports, according to news reports. I think we saw this on Fox 59. The owners of Landsharks say their security guards were wanding people. They pat them down. But in this case, the owners of Landsharks say the gun was in the woman's bra and it made it difficult